Will, what's good?
Hello, Hasan chat. How's it going, everybody? Will Meneker Neff. Yeah, that's right. Always a pleasure to be here in the stream palace.
Hello.
We've got Craig, we've got Chris here. We've got Felix coming through in a sec. What do you got? What's going on? We've got Catherine here.
Our second favorite Will.
Yeah. There we go. What's everybody, what's going on in the chat today? We got here. This is going way too fast here.
I feel like I'm looking at the whenever I look at Hasan's chat, I feel like I'm looking at the Matrix.
Yeah.
This is insane.
Yeah.
Spitterverse.
Oh man, I'm just very excited to see the setup in person because I've often been curious about exactly.
Does this make you feel bad about your
look? I just moved, got a stew. I'm working on building it up.
Says apparently only one mic is on. Is it my mic? Can you hear me?
Thanks for the Vanderpod shout out.
All right.
We like you. We love you. Are we watching the new season, Sam?
is there a new season going right now?
Yes, there is.
Okay. What are we looking at? The woman who scammed $10 billion and disappeared? Is this what we're watching?
Chat, I need some says Hasan, fix your mic.
The only instruction Hasan gave us was don't touch anything.
Yeah, he just said sit down and start talking. This is what streaming is like.
Yes.
Just gotta keep on talking. So okay, Chad, who do we like in the Super Bowl tomorrow? Any Chiefs fans in the chat, sound off, or if you like the 49ers, please let us know. Niners, okay. Got it. All right, we'll see.
Let's see if this is good. Okay, it should be good. You guys want to talk real quick? Let's test it out.
Oh.
Oops. Damn. Will is...
All right, I've already broken the studio.
Will is so fucking jacked, it's not even funny. He is, it seems, a leftist who works out.
Oh, that's right. That tweet was... Oh, yeah,
we're doing that. You're so quick with it, Chris. You're like already whipping it together.
I was saying that the thing that I'm very, very excited to be invited over, but I'm very excited to see the setup.
Oh yeah, I'm a bit of a nerd of this stuff. Unfortunately, that doesn't have a thing, so it doesn't fully hold on, so you can't clamp onto it.
Yeah.
But I do have the wide shot camera. We could try to use that this time. Let's see.
All right, I got a question here for all these so-called leftists that are supposedly working out four to five times a week. How about, or just working out at all? That's time that you could be reading theory. Studying communism, doing praxis. So I think the gym is a very bourgeois institution. And I think like physical activity of any kind is actually quite bourgeois. And that's that on that. And I think we've settled that debate for today.
Okay, well, I guess Felix, when he comes in, he's going to have a different... He's gonna have a different approach to this, but hold on.
The leftist activities you should be doing four to five times a week are watching TV, watching movies, watching TV and movies again, playing video games, smoking weed, and then I don't know, if you have pets or something, you can just dedicate a small amount of your day to pet or childcare. But for the most part, the leftist activities are watching TV and movies.
Okay. But here, you want to see? You guys want to see the wild shit that I have going on here?
Yes. Let's I'm full the capabilities nerdy. Tour. Yeah.
There it is.
Nice.
So this is this. I have like a lot of cameras in here. I don't really use many of them at this point. And we have a lot of mics in here. We used to originally use this room as like half of it was up for podcasting, and then the other half was my like area. I've slowly, gradually moved my space a little bit more and more to the middle. Yeah. It's a little difficult with the way streaming works to try and have it be like as open and as like hospitable, I guess, to people coming on. Yeah. But, you know, I try to do my very best here. Cutie might use your card for their dresses. Wait, what do you mean? Your house is slanted? Okay, shut the fuck up. I know.
because of the earthquake yesterday.
Yeah.
Everything tilted.
Oh yeah. You guys showed up, to Los Angeles and earthquakes are happening. How that's do you feel right. about that? You don't know what that's like with your city boy lifestyle in New York.
Hey,
okay?
I was in an earthquake out in Santa Monica when I was 3 years old. It was one of my like most vivid memories. One of my earliest and most vivid memories was of being in an earthquake in Santa Monica when I was but 3 years old. So, I mean, like, hey, I have earthquake-related trauma. That's fair enough.
Wow. But yeah, as far as working out goes, I think it's good.
I think it's bad.
I think it's good. Let's get this debate going. Should do it. I think, oh yeah, we love debates here. Okay, listen. I spent like the last 2 hours or so talking about how Tacoma wept, okay?
Okay, oh, all right, yeah. Oh, my
God. I think we got enough of that out of our system, so.
Tacoma's like has some light tears today. Just maybe a sniffle.
Maybe Tacoma is no longer, they're weeping tears of joy now.
Yeah.
They're weeping tears of joy for finally being out and about with their election.
They're finally free.
Yeah.
But in any case, for those of you who don't know, these are the Chapo boys. Some of the Chapo boys are here. What are you guys doing in L.A.? Is it like some super secret Hollywood shit?
That's right. No, I mean, it's like I'm back out here in L.A. I mean, everyone else lives here full time now. But Catherine and I came out here because, you know, it's been a while. It's been about 5 months. And, you know, we just like no secret project to work on. We have some things we'd like to work on, do some writing together. But for the most part, I just wanted to come out and
a couple Bryan Singer pool parties, yeah, that sort of thing.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's Hollywood.
Yeah. Yeah. That's how it works. Yeah.
But no, like just to see my friends and of course see you know Matt and Amber. I was just coming back from seeing Matt's the charming and wonderful infant daughter, which I can report is extremely cute.
She is round as hell.
She looks like Winston Churchill, yes. For anyone wondering.
Jesus. Okay. Well, let me do a couple things here. But yeah, this is my setup. Basic three computer setup. Three monitor setup. It's fucking awful for the most part.
Bethany Mendel's running for office of some kind?
Yeah, it seems. Felix is too busy not showing up here and fucking tweeting instead. He's like, sorry guys, I'm going to be 3 hours late because to the shawarma party because I'm tweeting about Bethany Mendel.
Oh, hello.
But yeah.
She's a big girl.
Yeah, she is. She's a big lady. She's like still a baby. She's not even a year old.
Wow.
Yeah.
She gonna get even bigger?
You guys met, well, Chris, you didn't, but I don't think. But you guys met Kaya. I mean, not Kaya, Fish.
Oh, yeah, of course. Day. Yeah, yeah.
Were you there as well? I think you might have been.
I think so, yeah. I think I met a dog of yours at one point.
Yeah, my pit bull, which... they all lie about like being anti-pit bull. It's like
you know, yeah.
It's fake. They buckled.
Yeah.
Will buckled immediately. As soon as he saw Fish, he was like, This dog's great. And he ate zero babies in the entire in the entire duration.
We gotta stop these XL bullies, chat.
Yeah.
If you see an XL bully, initiate with extreme prejudice.
One thing that the fucking British did right. no more do they have those like mutated dogs.
I mean, they gotta stop with them with the giant heads. It doesn't look like they can breathe.
No, but dude, it's so fire when they like. When they have those like crossbreeding,
oh no!
Like,
when they like, they release like a flyer, like it's a party or something. They're like,
yeah, it's my favorite, like pit bull, breeder,
and like they're announcing a collab between you know like the like a one of their XLs and a bitch of some kind.
Yeah, it's like the
Hercules X Athena. We're breeding the worst looking dog imaginable.
Honestly, it's like low key. It goes hard as fuck. Yeah. As like
okay, wait, this dog here is Champion Homicide. Okay,
it goes hard. It goes hard as problem for a t-shirt. Like I would wear this on a t-shirt 100%.
Champion Homicide.
I like that they show like the moods of the dog, right? Or you see the various. This one,
Homicide doesn't have range.
No.
He just has Homicide. That's one speed.
I love doing like it's not the dog, it's the owner thing while you're naming your dog Homicide.
I mean, I kind of agree that it's not the dog, it's the owner, because anyone that would own one of these monstrosities should be put down with their pet.
Venom line. Yeah.
Dude, listen, it's America, baby. You have That's a right to bear arms, and you have a right to have a mutated little freak that will absolutely eat your child.
I remember reading about how DMX used to rob people. He used to rob drug dealers with dogs.
He would use a
pit bull or a Rottweiler to rob drug dealers, and his justification for it was a bullet only goes straight, whereas this motherfucker will zigzag. Like, this guy will chase you once I let it. He just would go up to a guy and be like, give me all your money or I let this dog off the leash right now. And as you can imagine, it was probably fairly successful.
Okay, asking XL bully owners if their dog should be banned.
These dogs are doing these attacks and not XL bullies.
Oh, she got this shirt! Yo, that's the coolest grandma. Come on. Yeah. Come on. She's got the fucking XL bully breed shirt on. Fucking hell.
At the end of the day, there's bigger problems out there. There's monsters out there right now.
I love that.
Yeah. Oh, this is so good. Yeah, you're conflicted, I can tell. Because it's like they are shitting on Richard Sunak, and also simultaneously, this means you have to kind of defend England.
Yeah, I mean, no, like, and England as a country is a country, like, from their upper class on down, obsessed with breeding animals. It's a really weird sickness that they have. They love they love watching ponies fuck each other. They love making weirder and weirder dogs. So I guess, like, you know, now that the people have a dog, a weird dog they can call their own.
No, that's why they want
to
ban it.
They just happen to be Champion Homicide machines.
No, they want to ban the fucking bully breed specifically because they're like, only the royals get to do inbreeding. Yeah. No incest for you. No eugenics for you, lads. Yeah. Not for the commoner.
No, I have a suspicion about people that are really into purebred dogs. Let's just say certain particles are being emitted from their general interests.
Well, these are definitely anything but purebred.
Yeah.
Oh, dude,
there's
rapists
and murderers and everything else roaming the streets and paedophiles, and nothing's quickly done.
This is what's going to happen.
But they're not wrong.
England does have a lot worse problems than the XL bully breed. Yeah. I will give them that.
This is like England's version of Chuck Schumer going on a killing spree for any kind of flavored tobacco. It's these are the only things that you can fiddle around with anymore. We can't fund the NHS, but we can get rid of specific types of dogs we find distasteful.
Yeah, this is really going to hurt. If only they actually did elections in England, like, this would hurt Rishi Sunak's chances, but I don't think they do that anymore. They just dropped it. Like,
yeah, I know.
They've decided that the lineage or just like a random person choosing out of a hat is like a better way to run the government. I mean,
and people are pointing out in the chat that these dogs have killed quite a lot of people in England.
Well,
the British Empire has killed a lot of people worldwide. So, yeah. I mean, who are you to judge them killing English
that's
people?
That's exactly my point. Yeah. Is like, you should be against the bully being banned.
I mean, I want the bully to be banned in good countries, but I want them to be mass proliferated in countries like England.
Exactly. It's like,
don't let them cross the English Channel or the Irish Sea, but let's keep the XL bullies fully contained within Buckingham Palace.
We're gonna do 28 days later, but instead of the rage virus, it's XL bullies in England.
So I don't even know what happens like to these. Oh my god.
I wouldn't say that any American bully is safe.
Unfortunately, we're not willing.
They go hard.
Yes,
this
I love it.
So hard.
Okay, one of the funniest things that we ever did with Chapo, or the off mic, was finding this woman on Twitter who had thousands of tweets conspiratorially speculating that Obama had done a secret holocaust of pit bulls. Yeah. And it was like basically a one-woman QAnon about how Obama had secretly murdered thousands of pit bulls. And we read this woman's feed for like an hour in one of our studios sometimes.
Dude, that's so much cooler than like being into QAnon, I feel like.
It was
but QAnon
really
is cool too.
It was like, yeah.
QAnon is also
let me be clear. I'm only killing them to eat them.
Yeah, it's a traditional Kenyan practice, brother. That's what them Muslims like doing. They eat dogs. Them Chinese Muslims. Oh, Jesus.
Don't bully our breed, Hitler Sunak.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I love that because, like, obviously Rishi Sunak should be compared to Adolf Hitler. But, like, over an issue like this, is really funny. He's like, yeah, we're going to be shooting any boat that approaches the, coast of England. But it's our dogs. Don't go after people's dogs.
I do want to know what their takes are on that. I would love to hear what they have to say about that.
As I'm sure you're aware, among the alt-right, like the whole banning pit bulls thing has become like a proxy for them to like find a way to be racist, to talk about banning immigrants.
Yeah. They say like they're like, oh, pit bulls like are a substitute for like black people is what their energy is, I guess.
Protest by exiled bully owners who are protesting the government's proposed ban on the dogs. It does feel like there's something missing though.
I don't know what it's been said. Rishi shit is getting dead. Exile bullies are our friends. We stick by them till the end.
And that's a genocidal statement, by the way.
What we stand?
Well, someone said banning pit bulls is a right wing thing, but like, I suppose it's like a right wing thing if you're into being racist. But it's also just like if you have kids, like they'd like to see them grow up.
Listen, all I'm saying is. People never ask about the vibes of the baby that is being eaten. And I think it's fucked up because, like, some babies have bad vibes. Like, pit bulls sometimes have good vibes. Babies, bad vibes.
I just saw someone in the chat asking how Matt's doing. And Chris and I were just at his house. I can say, Matt's doing great. I haven't seen him since I was last out here in, November? But we were hanging out with his daughter. And one of the things that Matt was saying is how much, like, when he sees his daughter, he just wants to, like just take a bite.
Yes, we were talking about the phenomenon how babies do look delicious.
Yeah.
And how that, I think, is a evolutionary trait to make you yourself in the mind of a predator who would, like, if I want to consume my own baby, then so many other things out there must want to consume it as well.
Right.
Okay, I feel like this is the reason why you guys don't like pit bulls is for a different reason now.
you're
like, baby eating desire. Like, they do have a point.
You're like, I don't want the pit bull to eat the baby. I want to eat the baby myself.
More babies for me.
Oh my God, bro. Look at this
shit.
Oh
my God.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, hold on. This is why I have that big ass camera, the room cam. That is incredible. They can see it too.
Oh my goodness.
I hope you boys are hungry.
Holy shit.
Oh, fuck. Hold on. Let me help you. Okay, watch out. Get out of the way.
All right.
Jarvis, open mask. Fuck. Jarvis, open mask.
Okay.
Wait, wow. There we go. Which one?
Oh, your mask moves?
Yeah, it does.
Bro. This is the nuttiest. Here, I'll take it off your hand.
That looks gorgeous. That is a beautiful plate.
Wow. So I don't know if you guys know who Walid is. He used to work at Market. He did social media there. Now he works at Teddy Fresh. Is that a t-shirt cannon?
No.
What the fuck is? You have a gun.
No, it's not a gun.
And Walid is his dream is making shawarmas and
it's no dream. It is no dream.
Yeah. This is Will of Chapo Trap House.
Nice to meet you once
nice
again.
Nice to meet you. Nice Cheers. To meet you.
This is incredible. I'm very excited. Do
Jarvis,
we?
Open mask.
Wait, why did it close on its own?
Huh?
Does it close on its own?
Yeah, sometimes. Read my Uber Eats orders.
Oh my God.
We'll put it on the table. We'll bring some napkins.
Okay. All right. Here we go. All this shit out of the way.
Paper towels.
Okay. So what are we gonna do? Are we gonna fucking make these and eat them? Are you fine eating on camera?
I mean, if you're fine with it.
Oh, I don't give a shit. Some people get grossed out or worried about it. I don't care.
I'm fine.
I eat on camera all the time. And you guys can have some too.
Yeah.
There's enough for everybody?
This should be enough.
You think?
Unless you guys are big boys.
I'm a big boy, but I'll eat less. Okay. All right. What are we doing? Are we sitting down and eating? What do you?
Yeah, go for it. Here, I got some paper towels.
Okay. There's sodas in the fridge if you want some, Will. And everybody else, there's sodas in the fridge if you guys want some sodas. It's not just rain. Jesus. Fucking racists, dude. I mean, I'm sure they're memeing. Just Rain is back, right? He's done.
He has a show now.
Yeah. That is, I guess, Lamb Chop? Yes.
Yeah.
Lamb Chop?
Yeah, pizzola. God damn, bro.
And then there's some chicken shawarma. Mm,
delicious.
Good.
Oh, chef.
Oh, my God. Mm. This is so fucking good.
I should watch this
thing. Oh, can you sit with that?
I don't know yet. This is the second time I put it on.
Is the meat on the chest real? So, here's what happened. Do you guys remember that... Wait, here, let me close this real quick. Let's see how this looks like. Oh, there it is. It's better. Do you guys remember that there was, like, the Mr. Beast, like, looking like an Arab sheik that went viral that was on a food truck? That was his.
Yep.
That was his food truck.
Mm-hmm. And he hasn't sued me yet.
Yeah. Up. Wait, did he actually DM you?
No, he did it. That was fake.
Oh, I should. I'm pretty sure he's seen it, though.
Yeah, he tweeted at it.
Is
the food good? And so, why not come try it for yourself, Mr. Beast? Come on.
Let me call him. Let's see if he'll pick up. He might not. I'm going to text him first.
Tell him we can make a loaded shawarma wrap. There you go. You're eating it right with the bread.
Yeah.
Smart man. Get some onions in there too. Mm. Well, you get some tomatoes. Well.
Iron Man. There's another.
You want to pull the back of the trigger?
What?
Huh? You want to pull the back of it?
The back of what trigger?
The pita cannon.
There's a pita cannon?
Yeah.
Where?
I forgot where the trigger is.
Where it is?
Yeah, go ahead. This is. No, that's the PSI. The other one.
Oh,
there it is.
Oh. You just said you weren't armed.
Oh, my God.
It's the pita cannon. But it's also an old
t-shirt. It knocked the fucking the pizzola out of my hand, bro. That shit was unsanctioned. Oh, my God. We got to ban those, too, after the bullies.
Yeah.
Okay, that was incredible. Hold on, let me see if I.
Let's see what's here.
Here we go. It's. Did you make this?
Yeah, I made it for the pop up.
So there we go.
Wally, tell us more about what's going on.
Next Saturday we got a big pop up happening. I'll be in this outfit, of course. We got Yummy Eats. If you guys love the food, you guys like the food, right?
Of course, yeah.
It's incredible.
Yeah, it's really good.
So we're doing a little pop up in LA next Saturday. Got the flyer on the gram. You can meet Shawarma Man yourself. We got 30 shots on the pita cannon. Mr. Beast might be there.
Hold on. I'm texting him right now. Let's see what he says. I'm saying you're due social for Asia, you're Teddy Fresh.
What kind of dog is this big girl here? Does she have a breed or is this just a...
She's a mix. She's a mutt. She's a bunch of different things. Tibetan Mastiff, Saint Bernard, horse. Chow Chow,
yeah.
Horse. She's only... Here, I'm gonna send them this. Tell Mr. Beast that Ludwig will be there. Okay, I will. Do you like the shirt? Well,
I mean, shirt is awesome.
Yeah, I'm waiting for. Hopefully, Disney doesn't sue me for it.
Wait, who? Disney?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know what they, look at this. It's obviously, I'm making money off their likeness.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh yeah, so you're going for like more of a like a war machine, a shawarma machine.
Yeah,
okay.
The pita cannon in the back.
All right.
This is a kebab cart. I always dreamed of owning my own kebab cart, and I'm so thankful to make it happen this year. I know I make silly little cooking videos of friends, but now I can give you all a chance to come along for the ride. Thanks for always supporting me. This is it.
This is it, fully wrapped. It works. There's my muse.
I love this.
It works so well because it like we don't do catering.
So yeah. Well, you can ask about it.
Yeah, you can ask about it.
This is his co-host for his podcast, yeah. Zach. Waleed's entry point into white people. Yeah. Like Zach is the stand-in for all white people.
Well, we'll say, you know, coming to visit LA, the LA like food truck game is really off the charts.
You think so?
Oh yeah, there's so much good stuff out here.
Are you? How long are you here till?
I'm here for a couple weeks.
Oh, fuck yeah, then pull up.
Yeah, I would love to.
Where is this going to be? Location?
Eagle Rock.
Eagle Rock, oh, yeah. Okay.
It's 1770 Colorado Boulevard.
Hell yeah. Do you want to give some of them to the people?
Yeah, I'll bring it over.
Here, it's probably easier for us to do it. Yeah, I'll bring it over. Is the shirt for sale? I don't know. Oh yeah, watch out. This is why leftists need to lift, I'll take it over. Dude, this is incredible. I don't even like pizzola that much. This is the best I've ever had. I'm not even fucking...
Lamb is hard to cook.
Yes,
it's like
dude.
It's a meaty texture, but a lot of people don't like lamb.
Oh! She's just fucking... Oh, god damn, Kaya. Kaya is so fucking hungry off the lamb that she just drooled all over my leg.
She was licking the donut. This thing on the... She's licking the...
Oh, she was trying to lick the donut? Anyway... Hold on, I'm gonna throw this out real quick. All right, are you gonna? You wanna change out of that, or you wanna stay in the?
I can stay in if you want.
You gonna stand up and in that the whole time?
I think it can fit on the chair.
Can you? If you can sit down.
Yeah, grab one of the stools from your living room, maybe like the bar chairs.
All right, Chad, I got a question for you. What are some good prop bets I can place on the Super Bowl tomorrow?
How much cover time is Taylor Swift going to have?
Okay, like how many cutaways? Or just like how much minute? Like an over-under, like I don't know.
The top right now is at 5.
5 minutes? Mm-hmm. 5 minutes of screen time in the Super Bowl? I'll take the under on that.
No, I'm taking the over, buddy. Come on.
I don't know. Like people, 60 seconds is a lot of screen time.
They're saying that she should be on the new cover of Madden.
That's true. I think she should. I think it should be her and Kelsey. Let's see. Will Taylor catch the final touchdown? Yeah, I think so. That'd be cool. Gatorade color. That's a classic one. Yeah. Commercials, you know, like, I mean, what are going to be the big commercials this year, you know?
Oh, Doritos, of course.
Yeah. I mean, they can't do crypto anymore. I think Larry David should have to do another commercial where he apologizes for the crypto one he did last year.
With his own coin.
Yeah, and he got paid in crypto, too. I mean, if that isn't a plot line on the new season of Curb Your Enthusiasm, he's really missing a beat. But Larry David, unfortunately, not as funny as he used to be thanks to the vaccine. And I'm quoting the great author Naomi Wolf. Hopefully we all saw that tweet yesterday. I'm good for now. I'm talking to the chat here. Yeah, we're doing some deals. We're going to figure out what bets I should place tomorrow.
How much are you throwing out?
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I was just in Atlantic City last weekend, and I started sports gambling for the first time. And, you know, losing money on the Knicks, I was like, you know what? I should do this more often.
How much did you lose?
I bet $100 on the Knicks, which is like, you know, they're good this year. Let's see. Knicks are back, baby. I suppose if I would bet tomorrow, I'd be on the Chiefs.
But, the 49ers?
Nah.
Brock Purdy?
Nah, I can't bet. I mean, I don't know how anyone would bet against Patrick Mahomes at this point. But hey, this is a leftist chat. This isn't a football chat. So what else is going on in the world today? What are the controversies? I mean, have you been talking about how leftists should work out or shouldn't work out? What does the chat feel about that? Will, you're the GOAT. Will you review Pain and Gain on Movie Mindset? It's a good idea. Pain and Gain is a very good movie. It should be like...
The
Mark Wahlberg, The Rock.
The Rock, yeah.
Yeah. Sort of an underrated Michael Bay movie. Talk about Tacoma, horse cock. I mean, I'm not up on that. I'm not... Let's see, workout only for looking better. I agree. But, you know, if you already look good, there's no need to work out. So
I stick to TV and movies, and eating delicious lamb from the cart, from the shawarma machine. Shawarma machine, yeah.
I hope Disney reaches out and does like a new variation of the Iron Man franchise.
Well, they need something. Yeah, they need something going. Right now. When will Chapo become a Montreal-based podcast? Good question. We had a great time in Montreal. I've been thinking about it ever since I've been there. Which Star Trek is your least favorite? I mean, are we including the current run of Star Trek TV series on CBS? Because all of them. I mean, Star Trek Picard and Star Trek Discovery are pretty bleak. Pretty bleak, I must say.
Did you try sitting?
No, not yet. I might need that bar chair.
Bro, this is so fucking good.
You're happy?
Oh my God. Good, you've good. Upgraded. Like, last time when you made food, it was incredible. It was now, good. Now it's even better.
That's right. I'm practicing.
Oh, you want a bar chair?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're sitting on it, but you can ask for it. Hold on. What's your homie's name?
John.
John. Can you bring one of those bar chairs for Wallet if we can try and...
Well, Hasan, will your views go up or down if you start eating on camera?
It doesn't matter. It
doesn't matter?
Yeah, I eat on camera at the same time every single day.
You stream, so you stream all day long. Yeah. You gotta eat at some point.
You sure?
Yeah. Let's see if it works. Yeah, I have to, so I do that. What are some misconceptions that you have about streaming that I can clear up? Okay. Shout out to Dong Wizard on Twitter. They made Wallet's suit.
Yeah, Dong Wizard.
Mm-hmm.
Hell yeah.
You good?
Oh.
Yep.
You want to hold on?
Oh, there
you
go.
Need help?
Yeah, I got it.
You need help?
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus.
You need help?
You got you. Oh, man. you cook in that thing? You cook in that rig?
No, you're not gonna cook in this, right? When you're
No. I have a cook for the pop up, but I'll be wearing this for the peeps.
Can we take the gas canister off?
No, I think I got it.
Okay.
It's gonna imagine if fires again.
Let me ask you. When did you start cooking? Like, when did you did you cook for yourself like as a teenager or like younger than that?
So my dad had a bunch of kebab restaurants.
So I learned. So you grew up around the kitchen?
Like 14, 15, and then all his restaurants kind of flopped.
Yeah.
And then as I got older, I kept cooking and making goofy little silly videos, and I was like, you know what, fuck it, let me have my own little place.
People are asking if the donair on your beef is the donair on your chest is the actual real beef or if it's just a prop. It's real beef.
Yeah. This is like a cauldron of hot oil back here.
Burning my chest.
See, we came on talking about should leftists work out 4 to 5 times a day. I would say the skill that should be cultivated, and I'm serious about this, is cooking for yourself, because
agreed.
Ordering food all the time is insane. It all sucks, and I just think, like, you know, regardless of what you're preparing, I think any meal cooked at home is more nutritious and just de facto better for you than anything you would order out.
And it's therapeutic.
Yeah. No, I mean, like, I don't know. Like, when I cook, I find cooking can be very stressful, but also kind of cathartic.
Because it takes a lot of time.
And, like, you know, it takes a lot of focus and attention. And, like, also, like, if people are trying to talk to me when I'm cooking, I'd lose it. We'll get Catherine here to talk about my kitchen behaviors.
I have, I like watching stuff while I'm cooking. Like, I have the TV in the classic white American staple TV in the kitchen.
Oh, yeah.
And I play, I've been watching... Better Call Saul while I cook. You have a take on that? You like Better Call Saul?
I mean, actually, I have yet to finish the series, but I did very much like Better Call Saul, so I don't know why I've been waiting so long to watch the final season.
Bro, these are fire. It got real slow.
What do you like to cook? Do you have like any go-to meals that you like to do?
For me, what the hell?
Chicken.
Chicken?
I cook chicken, and I make breakfast sandwiches.
Ooh.
But my whole thing is like, everything I cook is very specific, like macronutrients wise. So I'm trying to max out on the protein whenever I cook, or whatever I weigh, whatever I make. It's like maximum protein, very little carbs, very little fat. So it's not exactly very, I think it tastes delicious, but it definitely could be better. Like, it could be better tasting.
Because you're just eating for nutrients. You're not eating for taste.
Yeah. No. That's a very boring answer. I'm sorry.
Recently, I prepared some a corned beef hash where I made corned beef from scratch. And then I did sort of a corned beef hash, but with the potatoes cooked in duck fat. And it came out wonderful. Yeah.
That's a real cooking. Yeah. I don't do that. I use frozen microwave rice.
Like, aw, boo.
Yeah.
You got to get yourself a rice cooker, man.
No, it's because it's like super fast. That's why.
The rice is so easy to cook in general.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I know. Sorry, I'm trying to sell food as quickly as possible so I can talk. Do you support local farmers or the agri-food, or is the agri-food system better?
Oh, the agri-food system is much better than local farmers or anything that's organic. I try to buy vegetables as big as possible from.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah,
bro.
I mean, I don't want anything. I don't want anything grown by hand.
You want to know something crazy? Before I came to the United States of America, I literally did not know that cucumbers were ever that size.
they're much smaller. The Persian style cucumbers.
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck is this?
No, they're massive in America. They're huge.
If you're American, you think like, oh no, the cucumbers that are like this large with like the seeds that are literally like
like fucking
like seeds that actually are
like poker chips.
Yeah, like people think that that's normal. That's not normal, dude. That is like insane. Hormoned out, whatever the fuck they have on there. However,
yeah, basically, I want a tomato that's the size of my head and virtually tasteless.
People get confused because they think it's zucchini.
Yeah, that's a whole different thing. And but I will say, like, I think like strawberries and stuff, I feel like they kind of get that right, depending on whatever the hormones are that they put in it. I don't know. I feel like some of them they get right, like chicken.
Yeah,
I love American chicken with the big ass titties, dude. That's my shit. I love that. I eat that shit every day, and it's been good for me, so I don't have a problem with it.
I had to lose a bunch of weight for this costume.
Really?
Yeah, like a marble roll.
You're on steroids.
Camille, not Johnny.
Hey, and if the food truck goes bad, you'll be in therapy, like exactly. Camille as well. If people don't like the shawarma.
Okay.
Your truck goes bad, you're going to see me in
LA
wearing this.
It's funny because someone just pointed this out about the Eternal, because, you know, with Camille's, like him struggling because no one liked Kingo. He was the only one that had to get in shape for that movie. They're like, well, everyone else in that movie was just looked normal, and like he was just like cut, like
ripped to the goddamn
He was
gills.
Ripped to the shreds. I mean, like,
no scene in that movie where he had to be that ripped either.
I just imagine, like,
isn't he like a god? I didn't watch it.
Yeah,
but.
No, I mean, they're all gods. But like, I just imagine, like, you in Hollywood now, you just, like, walk into your agent's office, like, expecting to ask, like, hey, what work do you have for me? And then, like, basically, like, a trank dart just hits you in the neck, and you wake up in, like, the super soldier, strapped to a bed, and Marvel's just like, we own you now. We will be injecting you with all kinds of experimental steroids and drugs to get you to,
I mean, he looks great.
That's true.
Yeah, does he? I feel like he looks weird. Like he did too much. He should have kept it at like a minimum, I think. I feel like he did the what's his face? The one that was in Iron Claw.
Oh right. Was it Zac Efron?
Zac Efron. No, not Jeremy Allen. Jeremy Allen is a national treasure, and he's Jeremy Allen is like I think Jeremy Allen is white boy Taylor Swift right now. He's having a moment.
I agree.
I'm just sick of people saying I look like him.
They say that?
No.
They're all, dude, I was just.
People say I look like the kid from The Sixth Sense. That's the one I get most commonly. Yeah. Haley Joel Osment.
No, you don't look like him at all. You're way better looking, way more attractive, King. Don't worry about
Thank you. Oh, I mean, I'm not saying, I'm fine with that comparison. Racist?
Oh, yeah, he's racist. I think you look like Lev Patel.
Really?
Very hot.
But you know what? Dev Patel's a very good-looking guy, yeah. So I would just roll with it.
Well, no, when he did Slumdog Millionaire.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, he's grown up since then. Have you seen the trailer for his new movie? It looks sick.
Yeah, it looks.
The Monkey Man.
Oh yeah.
I will be seeing that when it comes out.
People keep asking me to watch that. Hold on.
The Brown John Wick.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it is.
Wait, what do you mean trailer music? What the fuck?
Just the trailer.
The Monkey Man.
Close your eyes, and you will find yourself.
When I was a boy, my mother used to tell me a story of a demon king and his army. They brought fire and terror.
Wait,
to the...
Wait, is this Bollywood or Hollywood?
It's Hollywood.
Oh, okay.
It's like Jordan Peele's producing it.
Oh, hell yeah.
And Dev directed this, too.
Until they faced the protector of the people. The white monkey.
You think RRR did this? Like, you think
I think RRR really opened it up. I think it really opened things up.
It should.
Yeah, that movie was amazing.
It's not as gimmicky as RRR. Not saying RRR was gimmicky by any means. But
yeah, you better. This is a pro RRR.
Wait. What was the gimmick in RRR?
Would he carry the dude on his shoulder?
that was sick.
Dude, it was incredible.
Yeah.
It was great. The dance, the song popped off too.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Song of the summer, song of the year, honestly. I don't even listen to music that much, but I would like play that in the gym.
That song?
Yeah, not to. Nah,
I would play the whole RRR soundtrack. I mean, like if I worked out, but.
Yeah. All right, let's keep going.
There you are. You are a beast.
Mr. Beast.
In this city, the rich don't see us as people.
Give me the job no one wants to do. I'll do it.
Anyone who forgets their place.
Wait, Appa Shea made this? That's crazy. Did he make the soundtrack to the trailer chat?
Every day. I've prayed for a way to protect the weak.
I've got an answer to every prayer.
Yeah.
I call her Nikki.
Minaj.
Big bumper.
Nice headlights.
Let's boogie.
You need to fight for your mother, for all of us.
Anger will not quiet your soul, my son.
Don't call me son.
It's time to remember who you are.
But only love kills more when will they learn.
Just one small ember can burn down everything.
Mario.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for a fight?
1, 2, 3.
Wait, I thought there was a... Wait, keep playing it.
The reason why we were talking about RRR chat is not because, like, this movie, it was made only because of RRR or anything, but RRR opened up distribution and access to, like... Because when you make a movie like this, I think this was a movie with like, for like a while, yeah. Right?
I don't know anything about the development, but like it's more just like how successful that movie was, yeah. Featuring like, you know, like a cast that's like, you know, non-English speaking or not white and just like two Indian leads. And the fact that it kicked so much ass. It's just like, because I think people, you know, I think they associate like Indian cinema with like musicals, which RRR was, but it was like had just hardcore ass kicking in it as well.
Yeah, it was sick.
You guys watch classic Bollywood movies?
I honestly, Bollywood is an area of which my film knowledge is severely lacking.
It's
But we should say that RRR was not a Bollywood movie, though. It was a Tollywood movie. Yeah. It's from the southern India.
Yeah. My thing, I mean, this is not India at all, but The Raid, I think, is the greatest.
Oh, The Raid's like the best action. The Raid and The Raid 2 are like two of the best action movies ever made.
And I watched it only recently. Will would always, my buddy Will, would always try to get me to watch it. And for years, like, I heard about it and I never watched it. And then I finally did. I was like, oh my God, it's incredible.
It's incredible. It's like, it is like how hard that movie is from like the first 5 minutes. There's like 2 minutes of that movie that isn't just absolute chaos.
Dev Patel wasn't getting an action role and wanted one, so he financed his own movie and directed. When it was set to be a streaming movie, Jordan Peele bought the rights because he thought it deserved the theatrical release.
Sick.
I agree.
That's sick.
To be compared to him.
Oh, so any thoughts on the Looney Tunes movie being destroyed? Yeah. I mean, I think this is, this is not the first time that this has happened, but like this is probably the worst example, because I don't know, Coyote vs. Acme sounds like a very funny movie. I mean, I would like to see that. And I think the thing now with these, like with these streamers, where they have a movie in the can and then they just don't release it as a tax write-off. I mean, that's fine to do as a tax write-off, but I think once you claim that money or like take it back from what you'd be taxed on the release of it, I think it becomes public domain immediately. I think it should be seen at like every public library. They just get a copy of it. Anyone can rent it for free. It's just, you can just watch it. It becomes public property. You cannot just like, if you don't want to release it and take the tax write-off, that's fine. But then the government should just get all the rights to it.
That's brilliant.
And release it just like as public domain.
I also think public domain should be much shorter far as like...
Yeah, 75 years is a long time. No, and then like, that. And then there are many ways that you can basically keep that going in perpetuity, thanks to the Walt Disney's lawyers.
I think public domain, maximum, like, okay, if I'm being charitable, 10 years, okay?
10 years? Mm-hmm. There's not enough time, 10 years?
No, 10 years. Public domain, after 10 years, I get to use it. I get to watch it on stream. I can do whatever the fuck I want.
There's a thing recently where was it? Steamboat Willie entered the public domain and people were putting out all these Steamboat Willie things. And I know the whole thing is that with copyright law in this country is basically exists because of the Disney Corporation making sure Mickey Mouse never enters the public domain. What I want to know is what the fuck is the difference between Mickey Mouse and Steamboat Willie? Because they look basically the same to me. Does Steamboat Willie just have a little hat or something? Why can I have Mal make a Steamboat Willie t-shirt and sell it, but not a Mickey Mouse one? Loya, chat, chime in.
Mickey is hotter. That's the difference. Okay, listen.
Degenerates.
Earlier we were talking about Vosh.
Tacoma's weeping right now.
Earlier we were talking about Vosh. There's a lot of people that are going to be here.
Why is everyone talking about Vosh again?
Oh, he was. Oh, come on. You didn't see it?
No, I didn't.
Oh, you were just saying Tacoma's weeping just for.
I knew that. That's like a. It's this phrase I say all the time.
No, it literally, dude, it just stuck in my mind. And like when I first saw it, like 4 fucking years ago, I was like, this is what beautiful.
Yeah.
It's prose. It's poetry. Yeah,
exactly.
Step aside to like all those like Instagram poets that are like, oh, fuck, makes me feel sad. Tacoma Wept, on the other hand, is like perfect. But. All I will say is the meta or the thing that happened is, you know, I guess he was maybe watching a or talking about something on a stream, and then he accidentally.
Oh right! I mean, I saw that, but like I was aware of like the horse thing with him, but I thought this was just a joke, and I was like, I got the impression that he did that on purpose, kind of as like a little wink and a nod to the real ones, to the real fans out there. Although I will say, I mean, like,
damn, you're a real head.
With streaming and whatever, like, I guess this is like a fear of mine if we're ever to stream, is just like what I have on my laptop.
Why do you have things on your? This is what I don't understand. I don't get it. Like, I have never since I left Turkey, where porn is illegal, right? You can't like access it from the websites and whatnot. There's like a literal, like, physical firewall. I have not downloaded porn ever. It's so widely accessible. It's awesome. It's one of the greatest
things. Yeah, but you could still have a tab open.
Oh, you're talking about
tabs. I mean, like when sharing your screen.
Yeah, this guy fucking
literally...
And
I'm not just talking about weird pornography on my computer. I'm talking about everything on my computer. That's not for public consumption.
No, I agree. That's why you got to have a regular like computer that you stream with. And then,
why,
like,
would you watch porn while working? How horny are you? I work from home.
Jeffrey Toobin.
Yeah.
Jeffrey Toobin.
I'm tubing it up.
Okay, here, a question for you. Jeffrey Toobin, OG gooner, ahead of the genre.
Oh,
yes,
absolutely.
Or no?
Yeah, oh, absolutely. Yeah. 1,000%.
Okay, good. I was thinking about that the other day. I think, like, he's not... There is not enough respect when talking about Jeffrey Toobin, because he basically was like, before people started talking about gooning, including Norm Finkelstein, right? Like, before everybody started knowing what gooning was, like, he was a meta definer.
Yeah.
What he was, is gooning?
Are you serious?
I mean, I only found out about this like a couple months ago. I just thought gooning was jacking off.
No, gooning is like, well, there's jacking off.
Well, I mean, this
gooning
is like, but it's jacking off for like 12 hours at a time and then not coming. Am I wrong about this?
Is gooning just harder?
Yes, I would say so.
No, that's edging. What you're talking about is edging. Gooning is like when you're basically a competitive masturbator, where
Stop.
You like masturbate for like 14, 15 hours a day or some shit.
Whoa.
Okay, that's wrong.
And they have like goon caves. Like they dedicate everything to like masturbating. They dedicate their whole lives to masturbating. Which, by the way, I don't understand, because like masturbation is awesome because it's like short and sweet.
Yeah, get in, get out.
It's like, it's the most fun you can have on your own in the shortest period of time possible. Like, it's just like, I don't know why people complicate it.
Yeah, no, it's like, I when I found out what gooning was, I was like, that was the first time in my life I felt that self-abuse is wrong. Yeah. And like, you know, perhaps all of the scolds were correct, if this is what it leads to.
Yeah, like what happened to shaming type shit. Here, but anyway, his folder was leaked
because mm-hmm.
he had a fucking... He had a porn folder on his computer next to his folder mm-hmm. called taxes. Weirdest.
Which is a great place to keep all of your pornography is in a folder on your computer labeled taxes.
So, but the wildest part is he also, one of the folders was literally XXX GIFs. As in like he's cranking at the GIFs, I guess. Like, I don't really understand that at all.
That's so short.
Yeah, how do you jerk off the GIFs? I don't want to know. Okay, but it's weird. And then beyond that, it was also, there was a lot of, apparently all the 4chan freaks found out, like, immediately, just off the thumbnail alone, like, the quick snapshot.
Oh, my God.
He's, like, commissioned, like, lolly art. There's, like, art of, like a girl eating a horse's ass, and then the horse is, like, fucking another girl. There's, like, a threesome.
And he commissioned it?
No, I think that was AI art, which many in his community got mad at.
He's like the Medici family of weird pornography.
Yeah. His community got mad at the fact, not because there's lolly stuff there, but because there was some AI art. I swear to God, it's like a joke top to bottom. It's awesome.
Well, how does your chat feel about Vaush? I mean, I don't know much about him. I know he doesn't like us, so that's basically all I know about him.
And the
horse thing.
He's not a big fan.
He's not a fan.
Of mine either. I mean, he's hot and cold on me. I think like he's defended me in the past, but like these last couple of years since the savior of the Christian race, Vladimir Putin, invaded Ukraine, and I said like he wouldn't do that because that's really fucking dumb.
Yeah, I got a lot. Took a big hit on that one as well.
Well, I mean, but also I was like still totally vindicated on the fact that it was really fucking dumb of him to invade Ukraine. But everyone has been like, oh, you love Vladimir Putin,
right?
He's one of those guys. He's like loves NATO.
Okay, so he's a NATO head. Okay.
Oh, he's a big NATO head, but I don't really. You know, I don't really.
I don't know. That's why I stick to podcasting. You know, it's like
the
streaming and
leftist
and YouTube world. It just seems everyone's.
What the fuck is this?
Wait, let me see this. Let me see this.
Two times a less is Vosh versus Matt Chris.
Donald Trump and other prominent members of his administration are announcing to us that they intend to commit a coup in the United States.
So, I wanted to talk about something today. I wanted to talk about what I heard from a friend.
This isn't a fancy, you know, frivolous use of language. This is a capital C coup d'etat, a traditional seizure of government power by one group against the democratic wishes of the majority.
I heard from a friend who heard it from a friend who heard it from another. Trump is stealing the election. down.
They have been broadcasting their intentions now for quite some time. And it is clear to me now that they are committed to the following plan.
Dude, January 6th was my, still to this day, my favorite day of streaming.
It's the best day of television.
Dude, I streamed it. I streamed the entire process. Derek Evans has entered the Capitol. I repeat, Derek, do you know what I'm talking
Wait,
about?
Who's Derek Evans?
So Derek Evans was, I believe, a West Virginia House legislator.
Okay.
And he participated in January 6th, of course, mm-hmm. as one does.
Yeah, but he could have just been going to his office. Oh, wait, no, he's obviously in West Virginia.
He believe he hadn't even been sworn in yet.
Okay.
But it was awesome because I remember, like, going through all of these different, like, personal snapshots, like POVs, and like, sifting through it. And then arriving at this beautiful moment as someone goes, Derek Evans has entered the Capitol, saying his full name, and then finding out that it was the same Derek Evans that is a fucking state legislator.
Awesome.
And of course, he got arrested, lost his position, all of that, but it was phenomenal.
I mean, not to contradict Vouch here, but you know, I agree with Brace Belden that January 6th was primarily about having fun with your friends.
You guys wouldn't go in there if the doors were open?
I would love to. I would love to. I mean, the problem is I wouldn't do it and then expect not to spend some time in federal prison. So I think my fear of that would probably keep me from entering any government buildings unannounced or, you know.
Or maybe announced like Derek Evans.
Well, yeah, if you announce it, it's not illegal. It's not illegal.
He literally said that Derek Evans is in the Capitol.
So he's referring to himself in the third person.
Yes, dude.
Oh, that's amazing.
No, I'm telling you, I watched this happen live
my God,
and
that
Googled
rules.
It and found out so that he's a fucking legislator.
I thought it was just the official January 6th, like, you know, like sort of Don Pardo. Derek Evans is now in the Capitol.
No, it was like straight up he said it, like openly.
They should make an escape room for January 6th. We're going to relive the experience.
Well, now it's the escape room is called prison. Which, you know, free our boys, okay?
Yep. We got to get them out.
Yeah, free our boys until
the great escape room.
Yeah. It's fucked up. I hate what the scary Brandon regime has done to our big, beautiful boys who are political prisoners.
And I can't believe it. And I can't conceive it. Because we're under the gun and Trump's stealing the election.
After this, these memes are done, Wally, you can show us some of your favorite memes. He's a bit of a connoisseur.
Your meme head? What?
Oh, yeah. Well,
that is going to happen in 5 weeks. Things may actually end up being worse than I imagine them to be.
So it seems like people are kind of erotically enthralled with the idea of Trump having a coup in November. Am I wrong about this? Do they not speak with a virtual ball gag in their mouths? And a perhaps a butt plug betwixt their cheeks?
I'm going to explain this to you. And I am going to be right.
Just like the fucking libs who are getting off on the prospect of Trump doing a coup. Because they're just... Because he predictably is not accepting that he lost. Which everyone knew he would.
And this hits with the Chapo boys, too. Those smug, doomer dipshits who have completely resigned any possibility of engaging in good political action.
This is...
Dude, look,
I'm engaging in good political action right now.
As someone who said, like, listen, you know, Joe Biden is better than Donald Trump leading up to the... election. I feel like you are vindicated. I hang my hat in shame.
I mean, as I said in 2020, I said like on the show the other week, I'm not the vote police. I'm not your parents. Like you can decide for yourself if you want to vote, who you want to vote for. So like when I say I didn't vote for Joe Biden in 2020, and there's certainly no chance I'm doing it again. The thing I didn't do last time, I'm certainly not doing again this time. And people will accurately point out that like this isn't really much of a threat because I wasn't going to vote for him in the first place. But here's the thing: they misunderstand. I'm not saying it as a threat. I'm saying it as a brag. I'm just bragging at this point, you know, because I can't, I cannot affect meaningful political change.
Also,
I'm sorry.
He is demonstrating that he doesn't give a fuck about your vote.
Yeah, he doesn't care.
Over and over again. He's
and
like,
I also, I live in New York, so like, you know, it's pointless anyway.
Yeah. So, you know,
I was vindicated. I was totally vindicated.
M. Hunt says, Will, get ready to have the most annoying people on earth tweeting at you. And I don't mean your fans.
All right. All right. Let's
fucking
go.
Got him.
Another case of people jazzing themselves up on a fight that they want to keep having because they didn't get the orgasm they thought they were going to get out of Biden winning. They just got this kind of sad, seeping ejaculation.
God, January 6th was so sick. Only made better by the fact that liberals got, like, very upset about it, comparing it to 9/11. Which, you know, obviously, if we're talking, like, which one is sicker, yeah, it's 9/11.
Well,
okay?
Yeah, I mean, maybe you should get some angry tweets
now. I'm saying it was bad. I'm saying, well, 9/11, I mean, like, well, it makes me sick.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, thousands of people died on 9/11, and the only people who died on January 6th were, like, you know, people whose heart exploded because they walked up a staircase for the first time.
And political hero Ashley Babbitt.
That's true.
The martyr.
That is true. The martyr Ashley Babbitt.
She turned into a Shahid on that day, okay? Yeah, that's right. That's right. I'll say it.
Yeah.
People are afraid to say it. Ashley Babbitt, hero for the cause. Okay.
The main issue for me is that there aren't really any, like, good pockets of the left, I feel, outside of, like, my community.
I agree. Oh, there we go. Great.
Dude, that's me on a stripper pole from one of the strip
teams. Oh, hell yeah.
Add that to the cart, low-key.
Dude, yeah, put that on there. Yeah, you put Mr. Beast on, but not me. I'm Mr. Fees, baby. You got this.
You're too close to me. I didn't want to get sued.
I will agree with Vash on in this regard, as I also agree that there are no good pockets of the left outside the people that I like.
Yeah.
Or who like me, rather. What there we this? Go. Yeah, there we go.
Oh,
yes. No.
Champagne socialist, cock hidden from the world. Shawarma, yes, facing the world, legs, yeah, open, looking, yep, up in deference, leaning away in fear, cock shame.
Yep.
They fucking got both of us.
Oh, God. This is why I fear coming on your stream.
Yeah. They clocked us.
Last time I came on, like, we had, like, you know, 10,000 15-year-olds calling me a CIA agent. And now I've been exposed. Now I've been exposed. But you know what? Like, this is no shame in this because.
Okay, it wasn't my stream is the reason. You have your mentally ill guys.
But you know, like, this is I'm not shamed by this because of course I will lean away in fear and look up in deference to the shawarma machine. How could you not?
Yeah.
Look at this.
It could blow up.
Yeah.
I'll be honest. There's a lot more freaks since last time, yeah, that, like, now have made it their lives mission to be like, they said, you said, don't vote for Joe Biden. That's right.
No, I said, I'm not voting for Joe Biden. I don't care what you do.
You told me earlier before, you said, hey, by the way.
Yeah.
From the stream, you went right on to everyone and said, don't vote Joe Biden.
Yeah, it was fucked up, but he did say that. And he should.
Community. It feels like every other big community of leftists has some, like, huge...
And, like, I start throwing a few pitches, and it's, and the crowd's going crazy. And then, you know, I thought that would be cool.
No, sorry, Matt, Chrisman, and Trey on Talk Shit About You. No, I didn't. What, on Twitter or over their podcast or something like that?
Yeah, no, that Vaush guy, people want me to debate him, and I've looked...
What's the debate?
What would you want me to jangle keys in front of his face? He seems like the dumbest people I've ever encountered.
Is it jiggle keys in front of his face?
Really violent, this song, by the way. What a lonely boy.
This is like, I think, well, yeah, one of the worst aspects of, like, the debate culture stuff that people falsely smear me with and say,
yeah,
I'm a debate guy.
You debate people?
Because, like, I've debated, like, Andrew Tate and stuff. Like, I do it for, like, content. You know what I mean? I know what it's for. The purpose is, like, be in front of a large audience and, like, humiliate ritualistically your interlocutor. It's not about, like, using the Socratic method to arrive at the truth or whatever the fuck these nerds believe. And the worst aspect of it is that, like, ultimately, it leads you down a pathway of inevitably turning every aspect of your life into that same spectacle.
Right, right.
Which is this.
And also,
do you want to see the update?
Because
Ethan found out about the horse porn stuff, and he was blasting him on his show, and this was his retaliation.
Is like a threesome with two chicks and a guy. And in retrospect, looking at
the two chicks and a guy, the guy is a horse.
Okay. It's a horse. And not even like
Secretariat.
It's no, literally. Like, it's not even a horse that's like
a famous horse. Yeah.
Like a furry or something.
Yeah, it's not even like a humanistic horse. It's not an anthropogenic horse. It is a horse horse with a horse cock. And the horse is having its ass eat. I saw it. Okay. It is it is all over the replies of every single one of these fucking tweets. Yeah. It's not BoJack Horseman. No, it is literally just Secretariat would be adequate, yes.
Knowing now that that artist is a lolicon, yeah, I can see it. When I looked at it, I think the vibe that I got was like short stack, thick kind of thing. You know what I mean? The way like goblins get drawn in porn. You'll have to entertain me for a moment on this presumed share.
Entertain him. Wait. Entertain him for a moment.
You know how goblins are drawn in porn. I don't know that.
You'll have to entertain me for a moment on this presumed shared knowledge of how goblins get drawn in pornography.
It's not shared knowledge.
But you know how they're all like thick short stacks, right?
This is deeply esoteric knowledge. Okay, sorry.
Dude, fellas, come on. How many times have you commissioned goblin porn and then people go, oh, that's Lolly, actually. That's like a little girl instead. And you're like, oh, I thought this was a 3,000-year-old goblin.
I just thought she was small. I thought she was a mythical creature.
Yeah. You never want to be defending this shit. This is a big L. You ignore and you move on. But when you're like in the thick of it, I think you just don't understand, and then you create phenomenal content.
Yeah, exactly. Like you need to litigate every aspect, and like you take anyone disagreeing with you or getting over on you, like something you need to like have a fucking litigate out to hours. And I just think, I don't know, like I guess like the broader thing with like political debate is like, I just don't see like the utility of it, and I think it's like actually a sign of weakness, because it's like there are things that I just don't think are worthy of debate. Like I have no argument with you if you think otherwise. It's just sort of like,
yeah, like the ethics just, of child pornography,
just,
they debate
just
all
move
the time.
On, like, you know, like I don't like there's nothing to talk about here. Like it's okay to disagree. And then there are disagreements that are so profound about like how you see the world that like they're not going to be resolved by some sort of Socratic method.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. I don't know what you do.
You can debate like sports. You know,
I think you take some time off. Like I in a situation like this, like you have to, like you just have to take time off and just like maybe do a comeback like a year later or something. Cause like you can't, there's no way to address this.
It's gonna linger behind you for so long too.
Yeah. And another thing I don't like about debate culture is that like the worst thing you can make is an ad hominem. But I think like, the person advancing an argument is the most important feature of whether that argument is credible or not.
Yeah, well, which is precisely why all of those guys that go ad hominem are like number one experts at being like, excuse me, but methinks you bought a house in 2021. So that means your argument is invalid. And then it's like a different version of that cycled over and over again by some of the dumbest people I've ever encountered on the entire planet.
Well, because like it's just like there's never going to be like, because these things that people are debating about are issues of like moral values and culture and like just like sort of the framework for how you understand the world, and like that these are, I just don't think these are things that can be debated or there's any useful there's anything useful to be had in making a spectacle of it. It's either like you have confidence in your beliefs and are willing to stand up for them, or like, you know how to defend yourself if challenged. But like, yeah, it's this instinct to make everything into that everything can be litigated or like can be resolved through debate or conversation.
Yeah, it's some things you can't resolve, especially Lolly. Like getting caught with Lolly is you know the worst thing. But apparently, his fans are more upset about the AI porn part of it than anything else, really.
Yeah,
and you know, we're gonna move on from this. You stop horsing around and wait till things are more stable. The naysayers will always be there.
Oh,
you
what's just up, Michael?
Get back on the saddle. Yeah, he's right. Very logical though. We will logic and reason out of this. There's an Iron Man sailing donut behind you. You've noticed, Kudal. Okay, so speaking of Iron Man, that's actually Shawar Machine.
Thank you.
Shawar Machine.
Or Iron Man, I guess. Yeah. But
also for tacos, I've been getting that a lot lately.
Oh, yeah. Because it's carnitas, right?
Yeah, so it's multicultural.
Yeah. Well, I always say, you guys are gray wolves. I'm a panturanist, which is also a gray wolf of a different variety. or not carne is al pastor, and I always say Mexicans are Turks.
Mm-hmm.
Because of al pastor,
and they're part of the Latino belt on the planet.
Yes, which Egypt is also a part of.
Yes, well, actually, my friend Ev from Agent Napoleon pointed this out about the Egypt Mexico thing. A lot of similarities between Egypt and Mexico. You know, a dry sort of desert like climate, pyramids in both countries. Oh, the only two countries in the world basically that have pyramids. I mean, there are others in South America,
but that doesn't matter.
But
no.
the big ones are in
For
Mexico.
For the sake of this argument,
they're the big one, like the most famous pyramids in the world are in Egypt and Mexico.
Well, in Punjab, farmers from Punjab, India would go to Mexico, have kids, and then come back with brown kids.
There it is. More Mexico similarities. Do you know Peso Pluma is Lebanese? Yes, I know. Do you know who Peso Pluma is?
Who is that?
Yeah, Peso Pluma's name is Hasan, actually. Like, literally,
That's sick.
Who is Peso Pluma?
Peso Pluma is a what is it? It's a, do you know what Narco Corridos is?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, like the cartel, like sort of real stories rendered, real stories of murder
and
horror rendered in upbeat anthems. Yeah.
He's done some Narco Corridos, but like he's way bigger than that, obviously. But he does like praise El Chapo.
Oh, he's a fan of our show. Good.
Yeah, exactly. And he was like threatened with death by a rival drug cartel. Oof. Oh, this is the one. He's sick. I think his shit's awesome. Probably because his name is Hasan, though. I'm a little biased. I won't lie.
He's also very handsome.
Yeah, he is very handsome. But like in a weird skinny guy kind of way.
Burberry, all Burberry. I love it.
This guy's also.
Oh, I love that. I love that. I love that.
Incredibly swagged out.
Yeah.
He has a very unique voice, you'll hear.
Siempre pendiente. Que el gobierno es muy inteligente. Yo voy.
Okay, what I love about this genre of music and these videos is that, like they're swagged out for days. It looks like it could be a rap video, but the style of music that they're producing sounds like it could have been made 60 years ago.
No, that's why it's so sick. Yeah, exactly.
And
it's
he's
just,
Lebanese?
He's half Lebanese. He's from Chiapas. He's half Lebanese, half Mexican. His name is Hasan, like his real name. And he's the GOAT. I love him. He's awesome. He has like, and it's cool that he has a song about El Chapo, and then he has a fucking song about Lady Gaga, which is kind of like the El Chapo of music when you think about it. I will not elaborate further, but wait, what? The Big Bang Theory wanted to move Israel to Mexico? What? Okay,
Israel should be in Germany, not Mexico.
It's not from Chiapas. You said Guadalajara? I don't know if that's in, I don't know.
Shout out Dan. Shout out Dan K.
I also love look. They don't have this
I love
build.
How different these two guys look, too.
They don't have this build in, like, anywhere near. Like, when you reach a certain level of fame in Hollywood, this build is eradicated entirely, which is why I love seeing...
This is like the XL bully. Hollywood is exterminated.
Which is
this
why
look.
I love seeing this shit, like... You know, this is a side character that, like, what's his face? Jimmy Kimmel has on his show type shit. Yeah. You know what I mean? This build you don't ever see in Hollywood, and I love seeing it. Like, representation matters.
I think it's
a
T-shirt.
I think it's a
T-shirt.
He looks so goofy.
It's like I know what they're singing about. It's probably hard as hell if I could follow the lyrics.
But
doesn't he
look so goofy?
But like just like the way they sing it and the way they look just sounds so like nice or just sort of quaint in a way. Even though I'm sure they're singing about real people being murdered.
Yeah, it
feels
like he's singing to you.
Yeah.
Whoa. Oh shit! That scared the fuck out of me, bro. You're the real hero here. Okay, you got fucking. Let's see what the lyrics are in this, okay? Let's see. What? Siempre pendientes. Okay, we gotta translate that though. Come on. Come on now, rap genius. Give it to me. Okay, I don't know how to fucking
Google translate copy and paste.
What? I don't wanna do that. That's gonna be someone in the chat, I'm sure you have it.
Duolingo?
always watchful.
So it's Oppenheimer looking ass. If you haven't filmed this in Los Alamos, he does kind of look like Oppenheimer.
Peso Pluma is king, man of triumph and success and victory for Mexico. Hearing this again made me think I was back to working in a kitchen. Right click page and translate. Where is it? Translate to English. Oh, there we go.
There we go.
No. Oh, here it is.
Always pending. The government is very intelligent.
Because the government is very intelligent, I'm going to the front. And behind me, you can see a bunch of people. JGL, Joaquin Guzman, Loera, El Chapo. I carry proudly the boss's rule. I take care of the area. No one gets involved here. In a Urus, I go out for a walk. 10 trucks look back. I take care of Mr. Guzman's plaza, and I bring P as a security ring.
Damn.
El P is an important general in the military of the Sinaloa cartel. Señor Guzman is El Chapo Guzman's leader of the Sinaloa cartel. Okay. He's dropping lore. This is like a good lore dump. Yeah. And pure belicones corridos and throw it out Peso Pluma.
What is follow the orders of 09? What is that a reference to?
Translation, follow the orders of 09 or El Nini. El Nini 09, head of security for Los Chapitos, El Chapo's children.
Ah, okay.
And he says, making green with the flag of Ivan, here they come. We come and go with the flag of Ivan. Ivan is El Chapo's son. Ivan Archivaldos Guzman Salazar. Yeah. It's sick. I do like Narcos Corridos. I'm sure you've heard the story of that one guy who they like walk up to in a live performance and they hand him a note. And they
they said, you're
gonna die. Like, you need to stop singing. You're gonna die tonight. and it's like an incredible. I got goosebumps thinking about it. It's like a harrowing experience. But Chalino, is that his name? Waleed, have you ever seen this? We're teaching you Mexican culture right now, Waleed.
I have no idea.
Chalino Death Note here. It's so sick. It's so crazy. This is a death note. Like, the cartel guys are there, and they say, you're gonna
die. I've heard a bombing on stage, but this is...
death note?
No, we just read it.
No, I think, what was it? Like, was his sister raped by, like, a cartel boss or something? What was the background? I think the background is, like, what? He's a Mexican singer-songwriter posthumously called El Rey del Corrido. He's widely considered one of the most influential narco-corrido singers. Posthumously called that. A pioneer in Mexican music, he began composing songs for inmates that had stories they wanted to preserve in ballads.
Damn.
Chalino also composed and sang romantic and radio-friendly songs. He was born in Sinaloa. But basically, I think, there was a Coachella incident?
Yeah, he went in a headdress.
Yeah, back then, they didn't care about that thing. What, you have ice cream?
Yeah, saffron ice cream. Here, give me up real quick.
Wait, what there. The fuck? Wait,
I'll bring it. Oh, thank you. I'll be right back.
God damn, dude.
I brought goodies.
That's so funny. Are you going to be able to get out of there? Are you good? Yes. Yes, his sister got raped. So in a party, when he saw him, he was still a little boy, but he shot the guy point blank range. Yeah. All right, here, I'll show it to you one more time, though. This shit is like, it's crazy. Wild.
I mean, that is like every anxiety dream I've had about a live performance condensed into, like, you know.
Is this guy fucking popping? This guy's popping the weapons again, dude. Okay, what were you gonna say?
No, I was gonna say, like, that video is like a condensed anxiety dream about, like, every anxiety I've ever had about,
dude,
a live performance.
You're doing a live performance?
Yeah, yeah.
And the cartel comes up and says, this is your, like, you gotta wrap it up. You have to say, Joe Biden is my king.
Yeah, yeah. The Pod Johns hand me a note that says, yeah, we have a sniper in the building.
And then, you know, it's your last performance, dude. You gotta
hit
that.
I mean, credit for him for, you know, the show must go on. I mean, that's hard as fuck.
Yeah, it's crazy. crazy that like there's a vibe about it. You know what I mean? Like you watch it knowing what you know about what happened afterwards and you're like, fuck. You know? I don't know. It's just something that you can't really recreate. I guess maybe it's the story in and of itself, but where the fuck is Felix? The real question. He said he was going to be here. but he's too, like I said, he's too busy tweeting about Bethany Mandel, who's now running for Montgomery County.
Guess that's in New York.
I don't know, but
what is she running for, though? Oh, Board of Education. Of course.
She's going to make it so that, like, if anyone wears a mask, any child wears a mask.
That tweet of hers about, like the disgusting, like it looks like a coffee stain in her mask at the end of the day. And she was this was what was in my mask at the end of one day. And I was like, oh, really?
She's running on killing. Doesn't she homeschool her kids?
Oh, she's running with Board of Education. She homeschools her kids.
Oh my God.
That's like all these Board of Education, like all these Moms for Liberty people, like who don't even have kids, who are like showing up and running for school boards and stuff.
Yeah. It's just, I mean, it's probably better that they don't have children, really, but it is still weird that they like.
Well, they're still really involved in the lives of kids.
Yeah. It is odd. It is odd having that level of interest in children when it's not even your own. Odd.
No, I agree with the chat. Moms for Liberty is just a swingers group because there's been they're all losing their elections, but there's been like a number of these scandals where like they've been like, and these are people that are trying to purge public libraries of like any reference to gay or lesbian or trans identities or history or anything like that, who have been more or less living openly in like a poly throuple relationship for like quite some time.
Do you, do you want to watch one of these like YouTube guys that I recently encountered?
All right, well, what is it?
His name is Tyler Oliveira. Okay, I just want to show you something real quick. All right, and I want you to go down this rabbit hole.
His thumbnails are really great.
Yeah, so his last video is, I investigated New York City's illegal immigrant invasion.
Okay.
Okay, and look at the...
I'm living on the front lines of this.
Yeah. I investigated Mexico's deadly Coca-Cola addiction. I investigated the cancer capital of America.
Covered in tumors?
Yeah. I investigated a city that banned police. And these are all bangers. I mean, they're getting like millions of fucking views, right? Yeah. I interviewed the most racist man in America. It was him in a mirror. That's right. He's like, that's me. I'm the most racist man in America.
I investigated the city where every drug is legal.
Yeah. Look at what this guy like used to do though. He would do like Mr. Beast ass videos about like he would be like, I drove around the country in a Minecraft pig. And then now it's like, I went to the fentanyl capital of the world.
I snuck onto Jeffrey Epstein's island.
Yeah, dude. I like, and it's wild. I investigated the U.S. Mexico border. It
is
crazy.
Like YouTubers, like at the arms race for views is astonishing.
I investigated Hitler's death.
His death.
Yeah, he went to Argentina. Yep. Actually, he's based. he's like Hitler is alive in Argentina.
I guess with like Mr. Beast out there, like I mean he's one or two videos away from like building and detonating his own nuclear weapon, which I think would be awesome. Did you see the video he just did where it was like they just built that town and then blew it up with fireworks and like train into a giant pit?
I think like he's doing, it has to be CGI, right? Like I mean
I look pretty real to me.
I don't understand. Oh, the pit one was real. Yeah. No, but did they actually drop a train in it? I don't think so. I think the train one was CGI. But like,
I don't know, but like either he's gonna like pay for the national healthcare system of America for like a video stunt or build and detonate his own nuclear device.
Yeah.
And like that's what it's like for these YouTube guys, man. It's a hard grind.
Which is, you know, subsequently both
I hunted near extinct species across
Africa. I investigated a country where every drug is legal. I investigated if George Bush did 9/11. It's like, how is this guy investigating anything? Like, anyway,
I investigated plane crash. He's like, I crashed a plane. I was in a plane crash. I investigated a plane crash by being in one.
But yeah, his shit is like basically, it basically went from like weird, you know, Mr. Beast style videos to just like increasingly more right-wing content.
I mean, and like that just seemed like that is like gravity. It's like the way water flows, you know. Yeah. If you get into this gang,
I wanted to hear your take on it though. Like, right, I investigated the city that banned police.
This is Seattle, Washington.
Okay. Potential overdose. Anyone have Narcan?
This guy's still following us, by the way.
I'm insane.
Well, I mean, there's police right there. I thought they were banned.
Ma'am, are you okay?
Home.
Yeah, you owned him, but like you're kind of right. What's happening? What? Why
is this Seattle? Seattle banned police,
but it's not banned. It seems. I wish they had. Wait, doesn't this video also immediately dismiss?
I guess he's referring to like Chaz, the Chaz thing or something.
It's so funny because it's like they'll be like, "Look at how much crime there is," and then they show a cop right there, and it's like, "Well, it clearly hasn't solved the fucking problem." Like, what's your solution? Just to, like, murk every homeless person? Which I don't want to know.
I mean, yeah.
Wait, they can hear everything most likely. Okay. I think you just...
Yeah, can you do, like, 15 more minutes?
Oh, you guys are...
I think we got a jet in a second.
Yeah, it's all good. I mean...
Sans Felix.
Yeah, well, it's fine. This is... Felix does this to me all the time. It's fine.
Homelessness.
Just understand that you guys are just one paycheck away from being out here, too.
Racism.
There's nothing wrong with being racist.
Protests. Crime.
I am being trafficked against my will.
Chaos. Are you on fentanyl right now?
He's pooping.
Wait, you're taking a poop? And free fentanyl?
They're out here just giving out free fentanyl.
Really?
It's a non-profit.
This is real?
Who wants free fentanyl? Line up.
This is how you clean up the streets.
3 years ago in June of 2020, Seattle protests emerged.
Free fentanyl. Oh, it's because fentanyl's cop kryptonite. I don't know if you know this.
Yes.
So they're setting up a protective barrier.
Right. So it's
salting around your body.
It's a circle of salt. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you make sure that like the demons can't come near you. That's what it is.
Following the death of George Floyd and denouncing racial injustice and police brutality, these protests were met with a heavy-handed police response using tear gas, glass balls, takedowns, and arrests as protests turned to riots and chaos and looting ensued. In an effort to placate protesters, the mayor surrendered 5 blocks of the Capitol Hill neighborhood.
Okay.
The police evacuated the zone completely, leading protesters to occupy the zone, banning police from entering, and declaring independence as the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, Chaz, later renamed CHOP, as protesters vowed to occupy the zone until Seattle's police budget was cut in half. But after a little over 3 weeks of chaos, Chaz had 4 shootings.
Police
rape,
budget was
robbery.
Doubled.
Yeah, and also, they realized shortly after that, like, maybe they... They were like, hey, we don't want the police because we want to be the ones who are fucking shooting black teenagers ourselves.
Yeah, they did a speed run of society.
Yeah. Like, that's what happens every time you talk to a fucking anarchist or a libertarian of any sort. Like, you literally come to the conclusion we're at now, but they think, like, it'll work. And then until they're like, okay, maybe we should do the same things that we have.
Speaking of the illegal immigrant invasion in my hometown in New York, you see the thing recently where that Curtis Sliwa just like roughed up that guy on Hannity?
Oh my God,
and
bro.
It was like,
yeah,
like
hate crime.
Because it was, yeah, like they said he was like a migrant. It was some guy speaking Spanish and they like they physically detained him on Hannity. I mean, this is all coming out of this incident that happened in Times Square. Where the story that got proliferated was
New York Times is talking about it. I wonder if they side with Curtis Silva. not that disrespect my uncle too much, but
these guardian angel bozos who've been around New York since I was a kid, and like basically I've just seen them loitering around subway stations in their stupid jackets and berets. But now it's like, you know, once again, it's like, I don't know. It's just like they're all like 60 plus year old guys who are, you know.
It's like, listen, old people need to have hobbies, okay? And
I mean, I don't know. Like, the uniforms are kind of cool. I mean, see, leftists, we just got to have cool uniforms. When we go out to do vigilantism in the streets.
That's what the problem is.
We need to have matching outfits.
Yeah. Yeah, no. That's always, historically, that's always been really good for...
Well, I mean, like, the sort of inciting incident to all this was, like, an incident that happened in Times Square where, like, the story that got proliferated was that, like, a group of undocumented men attacked, like, a group of NYPD cops and, like, beat the shit out of them.
Yeah.
Which is true, but basically subsequent videos revealed that the cops basically just initiated, like...
Yeah.
They started shit with them, and they tried to arrest this dude's... and, like, his friends just jumped out. They just jumped in. And they tooled up these cops.
Yeah.
And like,
do we have the full video?
Oh my goodness! Thank you.
That's crazy that you made an ice cream sandwich with the saffron and everything.
Oh my
god! That's wild.
Mm-hmm. Dude, this is so good.
Here. You want
Oh yeah.
Damn, you shut us up real fucking quick.
Mm-hmm. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. But oh god damn. Yeah. It's not that. Does anyone have the full video chat? Do you guys have the full video? Like of the immigrants? That the cops come up with? No, there's not a... There's the body camera footage that came out. Which, by the way, such a severe amount of journalistic malpractice. Like, we see a lot of it already.
Mm-hmm.
Especially as it pertains to, like, Israel-Palestine. But goddamn, bro. The like, doing this on, like, domestic affairs as well is so frustrating.
I mean, I remember,
They ran it. They ran the story as, like, immigrants fucking beat the shit out of cops. Like, what is gonna happen... in like New York's immigrant wave of crime or whatever, and then like a week later they find out that like no, the cops actually singled them out and like were specifically physically bullying them. Anyway, this is the full video, but I want to know, there was a second angle.
Welcome back to Live Now from Fox, continuing now with top stories and headlines of the day. On your screen right now, a live look out in New York City, Times Square to be specific. A group of five men have been arrested, accused of attacking a group of New York City police officers. Fox 5 New York's Lizette Nunez live in Times Square this morning with the latest on the charges these men
now face. I mean, there's sort of like a hint here that the story was bullshit because...
Good morning to
you. I mean, you basically have to be on angel dust to just make the choice to attack police officers.
Yeah.
And like doubly on top of that, where you know you're in the country undocumented, you're like, yeah, what's a fun thing to do on a Friday night? Oh, I don't know, just start a fight with a group of police officers.
It's phenomenally rare.
Yeah.
Like, no, statistically speaking, it is insanely rare that, like, random acts of violence against police officers happen. This doesn't mean that, like, people don't attack police officers, but, like, in most circumstances, it's, like, an altercation. Nobody just, like, walks up to a cop and is playing, like, the knockout game or whatever. Yeah. Which is, nobody's playing the knockout game.
That should be the new YouTube trend. I investigated attacking police officers on the street.
Yeah.
Social experiment.
But yeah, so they glazed it up like this. Where the fuck is it? Hold on. I'm oh, here. And all then I'll show you what the full video looks like.
Ultimately put the surveillance video of that attack out to the public, as well as pictures of the suspects, which they believe led to additional arrests. Arrest after this video shows a group of men assaulting officers in Times Square. The incident taking place Saturday around 8:30 in the evening. According to police, officers tried to break up a disorderly group on West 42nd Street. When police...
I have two rules, bro. Israel and cops. Whenever they say, like, the story is one way, I'm immediately like, nope, I don't believe it.
And they were trying to... Yeah, break up a group of individuals standing around West 42nd Street at 8:30 on a Saturday night. That just is Times Square. That's what people do there.
Yeah.
But they were speaking Spanish.
Yeah, they were standing around and looking scary, speaking in tongues that they couldn't understand.
The person dressed in yellow into custody. That's when things took a turn, and the group began attacking the officers. Several people repeatedly punched and kicked the officers in the head and body. Police initially arrested four people and then a fifth person on Monday. They faced charges including assault on a police officer, gang assault, and disorderly conduct.
Finally, you want to pull up a normal chair now?
According to the Post, those who were arrested and charged are migrants who were then released without...
And then they were released, and it subsequently created the hardest photo of all time. If you see the double bird, the double bird photo where he's just like, yeah, fuck you guys. And of course that even made the fucking suburban small business tyrants way angrier, way more fascist than they previously were.
I mean, I think it's just people's like repressed need to like, cause everyone like has such a deference to police, especially if you're white, because like, yeah, you know that they are there to protect you. But for the most part, average people are just terrified of the police. They want as little to do with them as possible. And usually like, you know, when you see the berries in your rearview mirror, you're sweating bullets. So I just think people like get so angry at it because like when they see someone punch a cop, you're like, he should give you the death penalty. Cause I think like there's a certain part of themselves that like really wishes that they could have punched a cop at least one time in their life and gotten away with it.
Yeah. So here was the full story. You know, make of the situation what you will when you realize that, like, maybe it's a little bit different. The Bobby. You fucking see that Bobby?
You having a laugh, mate?
This fucking bastard. I don't know why. He just has like a very constable look to him.
Oi!
Look. Oh, dude. No, that's sick, call. Man. That's sick.
Why are you pressing like that?
Why did he grab him like that and separate him from like the baby stroller? I don't even know if there's a baby in there or not, but like regardless. Yeah, and then his homies come in and start fucking wailing, okay? And honestly, you got God, son. That's it.
I mean, that's how I know that they weren't born in this country, because like even my mother, I wouldn't dare try to attack a cop, because I just assume they'll kill you.
I've said this before, like at protests, you only see more civilized countries where at protests they like fight back against cops, because it's like even. It's like at the end of the day, you're still a fucking human being. I think it's ridiculous. Like, Germany gets a lot wrong, right? And I'm obviously not going to defend Germany for any particular reason other than this one fucking law where it is legal to escape prison.
You know what? I've thought about this so many times, and I feel like if you successfully break out of prison, I think, like... Then it's like, I don't know, if you're able to successfully escape from prison and then evade capture for like 48 hours, I think it's like sets back to zero. Your felony is just wiped out. You're officially free. I feel the same way about high-speed pursuits or just even foot chases. Yeah. I feel like they can chase you for like 5 minutes. But then after that, because it's like, how can you make it legal when it's such a natural human instinct?
Yeah, no, that's literally that is the philosophical reason why. Technically, in Germany, if you are in prison for one reason or another and you escape prison, the only crime they charge you with, like the only additional crime they charge you with, is actually like...
It's like some weird German law against cutting in line or something.
No. Theft of state property, because you're wearing clothes. Wow.
Okay.
So if you escape prison naked, there's no additional charges if you get caught. You just have to carry out your sentence normally, as you would.
Just like Andy Dufresne.
Yeah, because ultimately they're saying like... Just like you mentioned, it's the most natural human instinct to not want to be in captivity.
Or to evade captivity, you know?
Well, do you get charged for stealing the clothes?
Yeah, but that's only a misdemeanor. They won't send you back to prison for that. They'll just send you a bill.
Felix is here as well. Oh, back Felix to is back. Here? Look right. at that.
All right, well, this is good because I think I got to leave now.
Okay, well, yeah, we're
taking... Want me to go let him in?
Sure. Here, I just unlocked the door.
Okay, cool.
Yo, door's open. Door's open. Please look it up and show. There's a large list of things you can't do while getting out of jail. Oh, in Germany, there are things you can't do while doing it, though. Yeah, you probably can't fucking, like, kill someone. Like, that's not... They're not, like, it's legal to kill people. You know what I mean? Jesus Christ, Kaya. She's going crazy. Is there any food left?
Yeah, there's hella.
Wait, really?
Yeah, there's hella food.
They didn't even eat all that much? No, that's all my new merch that hasn't been released yet.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It's because there's bread.
But it's like all for photography and stuff, so I can't give them to you, unfortunately. No, I'm not going to leak it, chat.
Leak it, yeah.
I have to look at it. I have to look at it and see if it's good or not. Whoa, Kaya, calm down. Technically, you get charged for theft for leaving the prison uniform, but it's not that much of a punishment. Yeah. I want to watch these cops get pieced up, though, because, like, honestly...
¿Cómo está? ¡Vamos!
Wait, what? Wait.
He said that to them?
Why is there no audio here? I think, like, maybe...
Because they're using copyrighted music was playing in the background.
aren't the...
¿Cómo está? ¡Vamos! West 4-1. Go to West 4-1. Move! Vamos! West 4-1. Other side. West 4-1 Street. West 4-1. No.
Dude, what the fuck are they doing? They're like, are they corralling like random people that they're like, that are migrants or something? Like, what's happening? Also, how do you know who's a fucking tourist and who's like seeking asylum? Like, it's New York.
You know, like those people who come up to you on the streets like trying to sell tickets to comedy shows, and they like, you're in Times Square, and they're like, hey, do you like to laugh? Never respond. This is all, they're all cops now. This is all undercover. If you say yes to comedy, they arrest you on the site.
Wait.
No, I'm just kidding. Oh. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Oh, dude, I believe it too. God damn. Dude, Chapo Travel is those fake news. That's
disinformation.
That's why this is the only good leftist broadcast out there, leftist community out there. The guy in the yellow calls a cop ugly Betty right before he grabs him. Oh, that's awesome. That's the one thing you can't do is just hurt a cop's feelings. Your death penalty, you know?
Ugly Betty.
What's 4-1? Other side. Other side.
What do you mean, vamos, West motherfucker? What are you talking about, vamos a la playa? Like, what are we doing here? Why are they leaving? What?
The Lebanese.
Yeah, that's the other thing. You don't know. The Latina bell.
No, West 4-1. Mijo. West 4-1. West 4-1, mijo. West 4-1, mijo. Let's go. Move. West 4-1.
Why do they keep saying West 4-1?
Vamos.
I don't know.
I mean, it's like the other part of me, the boomer part of me is like, well, they are fucking annoying Zoomers. So like, they look like annoying Zoomers. So then immediately I'm like, maybe the cops should handle them.
Yeah.
It's, you know, that's what happens when you get older, chat. That's when you're like, okay. Being a Zoomer in public, immediate death penalty, arrest for you, go to jail. I don't know why he wants the cops to leave. Yo, what's good? Felix Biederman in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry, it took me a while to get here.
Yeah. Felix, you know, have you met Wally before?
No, hey.
We just had some excellent shawarma prepared.
Yeah,
by this
there's some more food as well if you wanna warm it up.
Yeah,
there's ice cream too.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. We're watching the New York, the asylum seekers over, like, getting bullied by the cops, and then, like, The cops tried to like apprehend them, and then they got pieced up, and then like everyone was like, we should kill every asylum seeker.
Yeah, no, I mean, this is one of those things where, like, I mean, like, no one who.
Sorry. Oh, good catch, very good catch.
It was one of those things. I mean, like, the people that reacted to it initially, they don't care. They will just say this anyway, but you know. Generally a good reason why just seeing any random video from one of those accounts is called, like, breaking 911.
Yeah.
You should wait, like, 2 days before you make any extrapolation.
Yeah, but it's also, I mean, I was saying this earlier, but, like, it's the IDF principle. It's just, like, if the IDF is the only account that has, like, first-hand information, and if it's the cops that are, like, giving first-hand information, I don't believe it. Until I get, like, second sources, third sources, like some kind of verification, I'm gonna wait.
Yeah.
All right, boys. I'm gonna they're gonna head home, but I'm gonna hang out with y'all for a little longer.
Oh, hell yeah.
Take the car back.
Will is enjoying streaming so much.
In the house here.
You enjoy Twitch streaming so much that you're staying the extra.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. I see how it is. I like that. Everyone in here does the Do Hard Bro style. Where the booze at? The fuck? Mountain Dew is the nectar.
I have a medical condition. I can't drink.
Yeah. All your viewers are like teenagers trying to get me to buy alcohol for them. Yeah. Bro, you want me to go to 7-Eleven?
No, that's like 2020. They were teenagers. I don't think a lot of my community is older now for sure. Like, I think back when, like, Zoomers cared more about politics because Donald Trump was like so captivating of a figure. There was definitely a younger audience in here. Now they're all fucking watching Kai Cenat.
That's like our audience. When we started, they were 47, and now they're all in hospice.
Yeah.
You ever watch those auditor videos? You ever like those videos?
Oh, I love those videos, dude. Are you kidding me?
Trespassing.
Yes, First Amendment auditors are my favorite type of videos to watch. The new meta for me is wait, hold on. The new meta for me is watching. Where the fuck is it? I had it open earlier, like detectives, bad cops, like police, like, or I guess like police arresting people too. Like, this lady had it coming, because those accounts are so funny. Because there's like one account that we were watching the other day, and the dude was like, he was making an argument that this 87-year-old grandma that was being like physically violently arrested
was actually a Karen who deserved it. And it's like, it's so distorted. Like, I look at it, I watch shit like that specifically because
do?
I want to make fun of
it.
Oh, she was 87 years old. She, probably she was apparently some complaining. Yeah. She was complaining. She was complaining about like a dude's like dog that she that we don't know. Bullies. We don't know if it was a service dog or not, but he said it was a service dog. And
okay, I'm gonna go on a limb here and say it probably wasn't.
Yeah, no, that is fast become like the number one thing people lie about. It used to be like some connection to 9/11. Oh, I had a step parent.
This
died
is Emma. Emma sent this in and said, "Best vid. This is mine and Felix's right. son."
Cheers. Bye
bye. Oh, I know it's really, we've watched this before. The one wearing the fucking OTF.
Oh yeah. No. This is my illegitimate kid. He's the right age. This I conceived him in 2015 on a floor
Michael
mattress.
Corporal Michael Pritch of the Little Egg Harbor Police Department in Ocean County, New Jersey, stopped his vehicle and approached a young man who was walking on the side.
Dude, look at how thumb-like he is, too. God, just a perfect fucking thumb, dude. Look at this guy.
Out of the road, after the man, like who we will refer to as Mr. Walker, gave the finger to Corporal Pritch. The interaction was captured on Corporal Pritch's body-worn camera.
Corporal Pritch?
Why are you giving me the finger? What? What's your problem? What? Why are you giving me the finger?
Because you're what?
I'm walking away.
Huh?
Am I free to go?
Why are you giving me the finger?
Am I free to go?
No. Come
For
here.
What reason?
Why are you giving me the finger? What's your problem?
Am I free to go?
No.
What do you have a problem?
No.
Do you have a problem?
No.
You don't have a problem, then where? I can leave.
Why are you giving me the finger?
Yeah, get the fuck out of here, bitch.
I love it. Yeah. That is so good.
He said, take your ass back to Cherry Hill, bitch. We don't do that fuck shit around these parts.
And I love, like, the Corporal Pritch is answering this kid's question, but in his own behavior.
Yeah. I don't, well, he thinks he can reason with this child. Yeah. But this child is unreasonable, okay? Let's see where it goes.
What?
Get over here.
Is that a lawful order?
Yeah.
For what reason?
Because you're giving me the finger.
That's legal.
No, it isn't.
Yeah, I read it.
Says
who?
Says it all.
Pull
up the law. Huh? Pull up the law.
What's your name?
What's the law?
What's your
What's
name?
The law?
What's your name?
How old are
you? Corporal Pritch claims that it is illegal to give him the finger, and therefore he can lawfully detain Mr. Walker for doing so. As we have discussed before on ATA, the Supreme Court held in the 1971 case of Cohen versus California that, quote, absent a more particularized and compelling reason for its actions, the state may not, consistently with the First and 14th Amendments, make the simple public display here involved this single four-letter expletive a criminal offense. Likewise, as the Supreme Court explained in the 1989...
By the way, I feel like Texas is the first state to pass this as a law. Like, it is a hate crime to fucking flip a cop off.
Yeah.
Like, and deserves the death penalty.
In case of Texas versus Johnson, while, quote, the First Amendment literally forbids the abridgment only of speech, its protection does not end at the spoken or written word. Conduct may be sufficiently imbued with elements of communication to fall within the scope of the First and 14th Amendments. The court also stated that, quote, in deciding whether particular conduct possesses sufficient communicative elements to bring the First Amendment into play, we have asked whether an intent to convey a particularized message was present, and whether the likelihood was great that the message would be understood by those who viewed it. Although the Supreme Court has not ruled specifically as to whether raising a middle finger constitutes protected speech, the gesture nearly inarguably satisfies the test for expressive conduct outlined in Texas versus Johnson, and courts that have reviewed the issue have generally concluded that it is protected
speech.
These types
of videos. How much money are these guys spending on stock footage? I watch like a lot of videos where it's kind of like this, but it's like, you know, the 30 scariest crimes ever.
Yeah, but it's like...
And it's just like, it's all like stuff like this. Yeah. And they'll be describing like a grisly family annihilation, but it'll be like people in a boardroom.
Yeah.
And I'm like, how are you paying for all this
stock footage? Stock footage of a Harridan wife with like a rolling pin.
Yeah.
Well, you guys have the annual license and then your investment pays off long-term.
Also, he's got 8.4 million views in this.
Felix, I know the video. You're gonna know the video I'm talking about. I don't know how to search it, but is there a way we can find the candy cop, the cop who's
Officer Delicious. Officer Delicious.
Officer Delicious.
Yeah, this is the feel good video of the year. It's very short.
Delicious.
Yeah, it should be on here. Yeah, first result. For, yes, yes.
Oh,
yes. I'm, very I'm,
wait,
good
what
call.
The fuck?
We got my man Officer Delicious right here, man. I just, oh. My nickname Candyman. We got my man Officer Delicious right here, man. I just,
oh. He's got a lollipop.
No, he got cooked.
He got cooked. Dude. You cannot be eating candy and no. an authority figure at the same no. time.
You can't like.
You can't eat a hot dog either. You gotta or a corn cob or something. Like you gotta eat it sideways. You can't.
Especially like when you're that young. He's like a brand new cop, and it's like you are way too young to eat candy on the job.
This is worse. That's worse than getting shot your first day on the job.
Yeah. No one. Yeah, he. They have to transfer him to like a new city now.
This shit can't be crying.
Yeah, he can't be a figure of authority ever again. They owned him. They owned him too hard. Face your biggest fear to win $800,000. Here's that Dr. Insanity video. I don't think this is the Dr. Insanity video, dude. I think this is just Mr. Beast.
Is Mr. Beast just like killing his friends now? Yes. Is that what this video is?
We'll see.
Mac is about to experience the scariest moment of his life.
I'm just gonna let you know, I'm not afraid of anything.
We'll see. You cannot scare me.
Seal him up! You have to survive 10 minutes with 1,000 spiders to move up.
Oh.
Release the spiders! Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Start the timer!
This is literally a fear factor thing.
The reason we're doing this is because Max said no matter how hard I try, I can't scare him.
Would you say you're scared now?
Just a little bit.
Yeah, he's kind of cooking.
And this is only one of many fears Max will face in this video.
Oh,
and if he can successfully face all of the fears, he will win $800,000.
Burying him alive?
This was
okay, but $800,000.
Way more gnarly than I thought it would be. 3, 2, 1. Lift it up.
Oh, I can't believe he ate that, bro. That's crazy.
The first challenge. Let's go!
No, that's just
but
the
Mac
first
has
one.
To finish all of these fears if he wants
spider,
to.
So.
Yeah, no, but like, oh, you act like you're gonna fucking sit there. Yeah, dude, I'd tank it, dude. If it was me, I'd fucking tank that shit. Spiders are nothing.
Win the $800,000 prize.
Yeah, okay.
I know you're blindfolded, but trust me, just walk up this ramp.
With 1,000 spiders.
Raise us up!
A room with one mosquito in it.
Are you taking it to me?
Really?
I'm exaggerating.
No, I thought you were.
I really do hate mosquitoes.
I thought you were gonna do that, like, statistically, mosquitoes carry way more disease.
I'm not scared of malaria. They just annoy me.
Oh, okay. That's what I thought you were doing.
Okay, you can hold on to it. That's cute.
Wait, what the fuck's he gonna do?
Okay.
Oh, Mac, dude, that
take
sucks.
Take off your blindfold. Welcome to challenge number 2.
Oh.
The next fear is the fear of
heights.
You're gonna stand on the.
You think it's scarier or is it less scary, you think?
I think it's kind of scary because you have no concept of when it's gonna end.
Yeah.
You know, you're just falling, and probably a second feels like hours.
Or like you have, or even worse, you have no knowledge of like when you're gonna be dropped. So it could happen.
Yeah,
at any
yeah,
moment. That
yeah.
would be terrifying.
Is that Mr. Beast Abu Ghraib? But like, you have to remember, he literally did Abu Ghraib torture to himself to become famous. This is something
yeah.
that people forget.
What is that?
You don't know what Abu Ghraib is?
No.
Damn, bro. God damn, it's like the famous American prison where they tortured all the fucking prisoners of war and shit and like random civilians in it's in Iraq, right? It's not
yeah,
Afghanistan.
Yeah, yeah, it was
the Illuminati thing.
No. I mean, the people running it were the opposite. They were the opposite of the Illuminati.
Yeah.
The people running Camp X-Ray, it was like a fetal alcohol syndrome woman. And then she was in a love triangle with two, like, repulsive other soldiers. And they were all military police, which is just, like, you know, they're, like, the prison guards.
Yeah.
They're just, like, you can't get any other job in the military if that's your job.
Damn.
Like, you are too stupid to, like, work artillery or anything else. So
Michael said, but enough Red Scare. Enough about Red Scare.
Lindy England was, you know, she was, like, one of those people where it's, like, you know, the chromosomes are wrong.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's too much or too little, but, like, they didn't get it right.
Yeah.
And, yeah, she was her superior. She actually got married to him. I think they got divorced after she went to prison. But anyway,
I did not
like,
know this deep lore
yeah,
that you were
I
in.
At all.
I'm a Wikipedia warrior.
Felix is like, Abu Ghraib is really a story about relationships.
Yeah, I love that you...
Well, no, it kind of is.
Because like Charles Granger was like, he was a prison guard before he was in the military. And he was clearly the sadistic ringleader of this. But the real ringleader, the Bush administration, folks.
Yeah, for doing 9/11. Yeah, not even Abu Ghraib, but 9/11 in general.
Famous, I don't think he's in the photos, but he was at Camp X-Ray. Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. He was at that facility. The head of ISIS.
You think they tortured him?
They got a couple. Probably.
They got a couple in him.
Probably. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's how. Well, and you know what else happened? ISIS. That's how Obama made ISIS.
Kind of. I like my favorite ISIS member. Is he's what he's
do
like?
I have to choose one. Do I have to choose one
out of so many?
Well, no. If you see this guy, you'll love him too.
Wait. Oh, is it Jihad Joe?
No. It's the guy who was like a pretty high up. He was like a general in the Republican Guard, and he just he's like a ginger.
The one that looks like Walter White.
Yeah.
The Walter White guy. Yeah. Yes, dude. Yeah. You definitely know.
I thought it was just a meme.
No, this guy, bro. Yeah.
I didn't know he was ISIS.
Yeah, the former Iraqi general is believed dead, but looks like Walter White, right? Iraqi officials said on Friday that former right-hand man of Saddam Hussein, Izzat Ibrahim al-Duri, had been killed while fighting for ISIS north of Baghdad. Yeah. That's so crazy.
Yeah, and he wasn't even like a lot of guys in ISIS.
This is the coolest thing that the government did, by the way. I'll stand on that. The deck of cards shit. Yeah.
The playing card stuff was like something that like a character in like a Frank Miller comic would do.
Yeah.
You know, like to that end, like you shouldn't do any of this, but if you're going to do this, that's kind of cool. Like I don't agree with
it. I had a deck of these same playing cards, except it was all members of the Bush administration.
Wait, really?
Because that's how much I was against the war in Iraq. Yeah, I actually did have one of those.
No, yeah, that was a big live
item. I live by a ticket.
Yeah,
dude, of course, from 2004.
We of course had that in our house too.
Yeah. Bush era liberalism is my favorite.
It's got to come back. If there's any hope for the Democratic Party.
Oh yeah.
You don't realize how fun it was. It was like. You're like your mom's other lib friends. That's the first time I ever saw Alex Jones was when one of my mom's
because he was anti-Bush.
He was anti-Bush. And one of my libs used to be so cool. One of my mom's friends sent us an Alex Jones video about how like the attack on the Pentagon was faked. And it was just such a like good time.
Yeah. Now like BlueAnon now is like way more boring. Well, so is Alex Jones though. Like,
yeah.
Alex Jones is now talking about basically one step removed from advocating for like tort reform or some shit. Like, he went from like,
I'm here to talk about our overly litigious losses, system of law.
Yeah. Guys, today we're talking about school choice. Okay, that's right. We need those voucher programs going immediately.
I just finished a section in the Conservative Media Project I'm working on about this exact same thing. That like. The closer Jones got to mainstream politics, like, his life fell apart the moment that happened. Like, all the consequences came tumbling down. But also, like, his show got way worse.
Yeah, but he also got, like, mass appeal, probably. I assume, like, he's probably infinitely more moneyed up after, like, the Trump bump. You know what I mean?
He was doing pretty well before that, though.
Yeah.
Why did he make the deck of cards?
It was to give to soldiers.
Yeah.
Because these are all the high value targets of people that they wanted to capture alive for deep interrogation or whatever. So they just wanted the average grunt to be able to recognize these guys by eyesight. So give them a deck of playing cards, you know.
Oh my god, I didn't see
this.
Holy
shit.
Yeah.
They're all like minting their cards and trading them and shit.
Yeah, the Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah.
This guy was awesome because he wasn't like he wasn't really into like the religious element of ISIS. Like he could take it or leave it.
He was just into the evil part of it.
Well, kind of. It was more like an ethnic thing. It was like, holy shit, like I'm, you know, Sunnis are gonna get like flattened out if we don't like start making evil videos.
Yeah.
That was a lot of people in ISIS though, at least the out of Iraqis that joined.
I love your yeah, you don't understand. There's nuances to this. A lot of Iraqis joined because they were like, it's fun. It's fun to have with friends.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it was more not universally. Like a lot of like the foreign volunteers, like people like especially people who came from like the UK that was religious, but like I don't know. There's no way to quantify it, but for a lot of people, it was ethnic.
Some people just wanted to lease a Dodge Challenger.
Yeah. Yeah. The people that definitely joined from like Europe or from America, I guess, or mostly Europe. Those are like all the revert zealots for the most part. Which like, I know, I rarely ever talk about like Salafists in the UK or anything like that, but there is a lot of activity on that front. I feel like on Twitter, they'll like get mad about like Lebanon being like multicultural or whatever, and I'm like, what the fuck, dude? You live in London, like
Every time I see a tweet, every time I see a tweet in English that's like Shia worship by crawling on the ground like snakes. It's always like location, London.
Yeah.
It's never anywhere else. It's always someone from fucking London.
Like, what the fuck happened? It needs to be studied. Like, the Londonistan memes are like, they came alive somehow. Like, I don't know. At first I thought it was like Katie Hopkins' like imagination. And then I do sometimes see some motherfuckers who are like way more right wing than like Who's the most like right wing dude I know in Turkey, and I'm like, where did you come up with this?
Yeah,
who's the guy? Like, it's the cleric he's like London based, obviously, and he's the guy who always does these videos where he's like, Drake is turning you gay, brother. Can you guys see this?
Yeah. Oh, dude? You guys gotta have that shit. You guys. So one of you in the chat knows what I'm talking about. It's not Muhammad Hijab, I don't think, but he's like. Muhammad Hijab is the one who's like also very aggro, but nowhere near as aggro as like the dudes that we're talking about.
Yeah. Like some of those guys, I feel like they're like MI5 assets for sure.
Yeah,
but,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, is it Ali Dawa? This guy?
Let me see.
Oh my God, he's 1.2 million. He has 1.2 million followers. Oh, Jesus Christ. The Wow Project. Okay, hold on. Kim Kardashian mocks Gazas. Okay, that's everything's true. Gonna be Israel. I want to see like something that's not.
Dude, most popular.
Oh shit, that's a good one. Let's see. Ali Dawa confronts Britain first. Okay, well, is it Ali Dawa chat? Muhammad Hijab is no Salafi. He said it before. No, I know Muhammad Hijab is not like that.
That video that's
full,
like
full and uncut is referring to cock.
Wait, hold on. Lindsay Lohan attacked for reading the Quran. It does go hard. It's no Sami Yusuf though.
Okay, that goes Batman a little Robin.
Hate, full of hate. Sister Lindsay Lohan.
This is not the guy I'm thinking of. She was.
Loki looks maxing my what? What are you guys fucking saying? You guys are such fucking weirdos. Why did I read that? Jesus Christ. Okay, we're moving on. I thought you were talking about the video. Someone tracked down the succulent Chinese meal guy? No. We're not going to do that.
Speaking of the Yemeni propaganda videos they're dropping.
Those are awesome. Those go hard. Amazing.
Dude, we're not allowed to talk about Yemen here. Everyone always... Well, we can. I'm just kidding. But everyone gets so fucking mad. Like, all of the horse porn defenders online have, like, antennas. They go... Brr! Oh shit, dude! I can't believe he fucking interviewed that dude, Tim Huthi Chalamet. Right.
Okay. That was a great scoop by you, Hasan.
Yeah, dude. I know. New York Times reached out to my manager to be like, can you pass this
fuck
information?
No. Fuck no!
And I was like, absolutely not. No, but like,
he was super cool though. And I thought he was like very like, you know, he was like the way he dealt with like everyone sort of like thirsting over him. I thought it was he was very mature.
Yeah. And the dude's like, I'm not Houthi. I'm just Yemeni. Like I even directly asked him about whether or not like he hates Jewish people. I was like, do you like as in the kindest way I possibly can, not by being like, why do you hate Jewish people? Like, I'm not going to say that. It's fucking stupid. But I would literally was like, what do you think about people who are like pro Palestine? A lot of like Jewish people lead the protests here in America. And he was like, yeah, they're sick. It's great. Anyone who's like anyone who's like against Israel's genocide is for me.
Well, I don't want to rile up the chat. So let's go with like a less maybe politically controversial propaganda song. Cue up Serbian Artillery is Guided by God. No, I'm just kidding.
No, but there is that one guy, the what is it, the Majdanin or whatever, the dude who proposed to his wife by using an Israeli artillery shell that did not explode near him. Did you see that? These dudes are like finding, he's a Lebanese guy, I think. And it's like they're finding new and fun ways to just like make make their lives more interesting with using the things that have been given to them.
Is this the guy?
This is not the guy.
I've seen this guy before. Yeah.
This guy's got 5 million subs, bro. He's mogging me.
My brothers and sisters. Like every like cleric is huge. Like the Saudi ones are like they're Mr. Beast.
Yeah.
You know, they have like 50 million.
Yeah. Oh, also.
And I like how they're trendy too. You know.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of them. A lot of them will have like Balenciaga shit.
What is this? Are you gay? Patrick Bet David asked Graham Stephan point blank.
The debate. Which of the two things to put in score, and you have to have one of them. Which one will it be? You ready for this tech?
I love Patrick Ben
David. Wait, you gotta explain. Who is Patrick Ben David? I'm not familiar with this.
Dude, he's the best. Okay.
I know Tim Heidecker is basically making fun of him on the new season of On Cinema, but I don't know like the source material.
Okay.
He's sort of like a business success win kind of guy.
No. He's like a multi-level marketing guy.
Oh, even better. As I repeat myself.
And basically, he's a multi-level marketing guy. And he basically fucking has his podcast where it's called Valuetainment. I think he's Iranian.
He's Iranian.
I was shocked when I found out this guy wasn't Israeli. His name is Patrick Ben David.
His name is Patrick Bet David,
and he runs Valuetainment. I was like, this is the most Israeli guy that ever lived. No.
No, he's Iranian, and I don't think he's like Iranian Jewish either. He's Iranian Christian, like maybe Armenian descent as well.
In Jacob Bacharach's debut novel, there's a character who's a lawyer named David Ben David. It's one of the funniest characters in the whole book.
Yeah.
Only shows up in the last chapter, but he's really good.
No, he's not Cuban. No.
No.
But I always say Iranians are the Cubans of the MENA region. So they
honestly,
are very
Yeah.
He's also awesome because
their expat community is great.
In this community we call him Evil Jank because he kind of looks like Jank a little bit. But skinnier.
It's to be gay, lesbian, bisexual, queer, trans, and they have to know at an early age because it's part of us being free and not being discriminatory. Which of those two would you want your kids to learn about? And you have to give up the other.
I feel like there has to be a balance because you don't want to be oppressive.
So this is Graham Stephan. This is Graham Stephan. He's also like a motivational get your money up, not your funny up kind of guy.
Being the clone of Tobey Maguire that they use for organs.
No, he's a landlord. I think he owns like a lot of properties or something.
So I have a lot of reasons to like this.
That's bootleg Tobey Maguire and bootleg Paul Joseph Watson.
I actually went on an interview with them. They were very good. I don't know how else to describe it. They were very centrist on it, kind of, if that makes sense. Like they let me explain my positions on like landlords and stuff like that, and you know they even put the information afterwards, like when I was spitting facts at them about homelessness.
They're straight shooters.
They are straight shooters. Yeah.
All right. I spoke too soon. I like that. I like the green screen that Patrick Bet David always uses for his interviews because it's like. The conceit here is like we're having a nice, relaxing day at the beach where I'm spending 2 hours berating you, asking you if like I 3-year-olds should be on puberty blockers.
Yeah.
I'm talking to you. We're at the beach and we're talking about top surgery all day.
I do think that Patrick Bet David, like weirdly enough, I don't think he's like that invested in the meta. I think he's more like, I think he also is more agreeable as well. He's like a little bit more normal, or maybe he's like too busy being fucking valuetaining, I guess.
He is more into the valuetainment aspect of life, but I have seen some like dumb culture war shit from him, but I mean,
But he's not like a Matt Walsh type who's like talking about baby genitals like every day.
Yeah,
so
his lips aren't as kissable as Matt Walsh.
Yeah.
Yeah, your kid is gay. You don't want them to feel like they can't be accepted and they can't be themselves. But at the same time, there's got to be some sort of.
You got to pick one of them. You got to pick.
Oh, yes.
I love him because he's so intense.
Yeah.
Dude. He can be talking about anything. He can be talking about anything, and he's always has the same intensity. He's like, no, you have to pick one of them.
He's like Anton Chigurh.
Do I have to call it?
Yeah.
I love this idea. Like, you're having a nice day at the beach. It's the day that you're going to propose, and this guy just wanders.
Yeah, he has one of those, like, cow pokers.
He's got the cattle gun. He's like, would you marry this? Would you marry this woman, the love of your life, or take $10 million right now?
Dude, he got this commission, dude.
I love this.
Oh, is that him with Lincoln and Milton Friedman? Wait, Milton Friedman, Martin Luther King, Einstein, Kennedy, and then a NASCAR driver? Is that it's a fucking
Dale
Earnhardt?
Why is the Shah? Why is the Shah in the middle?
That is really overselling the Shah.
Yeah.
That he's like on a level with Lincoln.
On the same level Lincoln and Albert Einstein.
Also fucking Milton Friedman too.
Well, I love Milton Friedman next to Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
They were friends.
Yeah, they were buddies.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, if Martin Luther King were still alive, he would definitely be an Austrian economics.
I love that Patrick is like next to Tupac and he's like, okay, I'll introduce
these
you to
are
the group.
My friends. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's Senna. Who's Senna? Is that the
Ayrton
racer guy?
Senna was the subject of the best sports documentary ever. Senna. He was an F1 driver.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Senna. No, I thought it was Dale Earnhardt.
It's sick. It's sick because like MLK's taking notes from all these wonderful people. Like Patrick,
I gotta get this fire in my next.
Yeah. Just like, if your son's gay, he's a big one. That's the conversation.
Dude,
he's in purgatory. He can meet all these historical figures, and he's like, would you accept $10 million, but your son is gay, or would you be $100,000 in debt? But your son has a 12-inch dick and he's straight.
I'm okay taking notes.
Dude, that would be so much more entertaining if he was asking questions like that. I like that. Yeah, the only Patrick Bet David video, a guy who only watched this one thinking that he only does the TikTok style questions. It's like LGBT rights or healthcare.
Gay son or thought daughter?
Yeah.
Come on, girl.
I don't know, man. I don't.
So that's a problem. But that's a problem.
Yeah.
And the reason why that's a problem is the following thing.
It's not a problem. You invented this in your head.
Are you gay?
Me? No.
What do I need to do?
What the fuck?
They got him.
That is some value, Damon.
This guy fucking rules.
No, I imagine him always like getting up in the middle of a debate and be like, are you not valuetained? Like, I feel like that's his thing. I am fucking valuetained every time I watch him. I don't know what it is.
Does he make merch? I want to see.
I imagine he has the ugliest, like, crypto looking lion. You know what I mean? There you go, the logo.
Yeah. Yes, it's probably like, yeah.
I thought that was an ape of some kind.
Yeah.
It's probably like the lion on the front, and on the back is like a Patrick Bet David quote. Something.
Yeah.
Something that's like, you know, compound interest is money gained.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a problem. It's the following thing. Are you gay?
I like that he waits. Like, he's like, this is going to be a big one.
What do I need to do to convert you to being gay?
I don't think you can.
You don't think I could convert you to being gay?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this.
Dude, he's trying to. No. His brain is like a mystery. The way it works is so fantastic. I'm not even kidding. He thinks
he's convincing me to be gay.
He thinks he has this line of thought right now that he is going to put forward is going to blow your fucking mind. He thinks he's like doing mathematics.
Right, I need to hear this.
Who converted you into getting a real estate license?
I did.
Who influenced you, though? How did you learn about real estate?
Saw a TV commercial for $1 million listing.
Perfect. So
got it in my mind.
And you were influenced to be a realtor.
Oh my God.
You were born with one to be a realtor.
Yes.
Bingo.
Yes. Yeah.
Did you get it?
No.
Let me explain to you what I mean by this.
Sure. Adult, what are you talking about?
He's right. He's right in your frame. He's right in your scheme.
He's so right.
Like, television can influence you to get a real estate license, so it can also influence you to alter your sexuality.
Yes, it influences you to suck a dick, dude.
I remember when I got my bottom certification.
dude, it's so good. It's so good that, like, yes, being a property owner is biological. Just like being gay. Oh my God. He's so awesome.
He set up this entire interview just for that.
Yeah.
That came to him when he was, like, spending 8 days in a sauna. And he was like, I'm going to bust this out on Valuedainment.
2 minutes, so he was ready for it.
Yeah, he couldn't hold it in any longer.
Please. So, stats came out that shows which generation is the gayest generation of all. It's part of the LGBTQ
community. Bro, he's got empirical evidence! Oh, dude, empirical evidence lovers destroyed. What's up, dude?
Well, guess which generation you think
it's Gen Z. I can literally give you the details off the top of my head. 26% of Gen Z are gay or identify as queer, as opposed to, like, I think 10.6% of millennials. So his argument is going to be television making them gay, which is awesome.
Do you think you care more about what I think at this age or when you were 14 years old?
Definitely 14.
No problem. Me too, right? So
no problem.
Do you think it's easier to convert you in a way of thinking at 14 or 33?
14.
Of course, right? Okay. I became a Christian because somebody talked to me about it. I got into insurance because somebody influenced me to get into insurance. Okay. I got into bodybuilding because
Oh my God.
Please take it one step further.
Okay, dude, it's a lock. Yeah. You know, choose your enemies wisely. Business planning for the audacious few. Your next 5 moves. Master the art of business strategy.
What I'm getting. Yeah. I'm getting my family all of this shit for Christmas.
It's like Lakers colors.
I think his error here is that he thinks that homo and heterosexuality are just different ways of thinking.
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, no,
the boss collection is sick.
Oh, the entrepreneur set.
The set?
Yeah, if you get one of these leather keychains, dude, your life will change. You will have an MLM.
Imagine showing up to a date with a Patrick Bet-David leather backpack. I would be shocked if you're not getting blown on the spot.
Dude, the boss set? What's happening?
Bro, only $350?
That's it? You get Patrick Bet-David limited edition steel dice.
Oh my God. And it says outwork on it and energize.
Oh.
This is phenomenal.
We're
dude.
Playing D&D with Patrick Bet-David rules.
Yeah.
My cleric proposes a marketing strategy.
It's funny because the lion, or at least the male lion, is
They have an athletic collection. It's sold out.
Go. Damn.
Dude, this is
that
like,
doesn't surprise me.
Blue athletic t-shirt. Dude, he only has the shield. What is this stock art shield that he has that he just like...
Are you kidding me? That is the official animal of Valuetainment.
Well, I was going to say, male lions are notoriously among the laziest animals on the planet.
Yeah, but they don't work. But they look fucking
they're collecting
sick.
No, they're not lazy. They're collecting passive income.
Yeah, exactly.
Because I was influenced by Arnold Schwarzenegger. I went to Santa Monica Community College because I was influenced, because that's where Arnold went. Influenced. Somebody influenced you, right?
Wait, what?
Four generations.
That is one
five
of the dumbest things I've ever heard. I need to go to Arnold's Community College. It's dude, probably better Arnold than all the other here. Ones.
Yeah. Famous for you know, his educational pursuits. That's awesome.
That's like Arnold just came into Community College unformed. He was just like a nerd.
And he didn't even
like lifting weights till he was there.
They're like, Arnold, you have to become the Terminator.
Dude, the thing I love about him is that, like, I feel like people don't watch him and appreciate him for the reasons that we appreciate him. I think there are a lot of people who just, like, think like he does.
I saw Joe Rogan just slobbering all over him. It was a horrible display. I saw a video. Of course, Patrick Bet-David reposted it. But it's a video of Joe Rogan being like, he's so smart and he's made so much money. And he's only doing Valuetainment so people can learn from him. He's such a good guy.
Yeah.
The shitty part is it's such a good name. Valuetainment.
Yeah.
I love Valuetainment.
I mean, it's like, it's straight QVC, I think. Like, it's very, it's so basic. It's as basic as a Stockart Lion. I love it. There's, I am being Valuetainment.
Traditionalist.
Always.
You got the boomers, millennials, Gen X, and you got.
But, oh, the thing I wanted to point to, fuck, I keep pausing. I'm sorry. But the thing I wanted to point to is like, he always has these like very convoluted, completely irrelevant sequence of thoughts that he springs together to like seemingly make this compelling argument. Like he went from, he went from like, you know, who do you think is the gayest generation? And it's like, and they watch TV, right? You watch TV, you're gay. Like,
Gen Z.
It's awesome.
You ready? Traditionalist, 0.8% of are gay. 0.8% of traditionalists are gay. Boomers, 2.6%. Then you go to 5%.
The data he's presenting here.
Yeah, no, we can't because he's right. He's
percent.
Right.
No, he watched Band of Brothers, and he was like 0.8% of these guys are gay.
I guarantee you, they're not. I mean, like it's identifying as gay, but like if you believe 0.5% of the male population in 1940 never did anything gay. Well, I got some Valuetainment I need to sell you.
There was no stigma. There's no stigma like to coming out as pan in 1941.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He is boomer train wrecks. You're
I think
right.
The Gen Z identifies as LGBTQ. 21%.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
21%. So who do you think cares less about what you and I think? Traditionalists or Gen Zs? Traditionalists. You think if you and I are 70 years old and we're gay, do you really think you and I care about
imagine
what other people
me and
think.
You are
what
making
do you think?
A lemon
no.
Party.
You're coming out. You ever seen a grandma or grandfather drop F-bombs and it's like, get your butt out of my... Because that... You know, listen, I'm 10 years away from living and dying. Like, I don't give a shit what you think
what?
About...
Oh, my
what
God.
What the fuck are
oh
you
my
talking?
God. Oh, my God. Oh, I just picked it up. He was... It's hard to pick up because he's such high... He's bringing such high-level ideas.
Yeah.
Okay? Yeah, he's overheating.
You have to have a really high IQ to understand what Patrick Bet-David is saying. No, he's saying it's impossible to influence old people because they say slurs, as evidenced by the fact that they say slurs because they're going to die soon. Who cares? But it's very easy to influence children. So that's the reason why gay people are influenced into being gay when they're children.
Can I just point out that he said old people are 10 years away from living and dying? So, well, which one?
What age?
No, it's prose, man. It's like Tacoma wept. He's doing prose. He's like, you don't understand. This is high-level poetry. Yeah. He's a poetic guy. It's a bar.
But if 21% of Gen Z is gay, they're being influenced just like you were influenced to be a realtor, just like I was influenced to go into SMC. Influence. That's a problem. So the fact that you, a very smart guy, a super successful guy at your age, cannot tell the two apart, that means you're not really putting a lot of thought into what's going to influence who. Because
he is, though.
Yeah.
He's always thinking about how influenced the youth is about getting gay.
What is God, SMC influence? The thing that he said he was influenced into getting into.
Oh, SMC Santa Monica College.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. He was influenced by Arnold to go to SMC, which is, you know, the Harvard of the West. The Harvard of community colleges in
Faith,
the West.
That's going to influence you to do what? Completely different thing.
Don't you think that some of that, though, is a bit of that overall people are...
Bro, the most effective counter to this, not to be like an annoying debate guy, is to be like, so when did you get influenced to like pussy, my
man?
What happened? Like, what movie convinced you that pussy is the shit?
Because
when you say that, when you say something like that, it's going to be like, what? I love
eat pussy.
Yeah, I love pussy. I've always loved pussy. Like, who taught you to be fucking into women?
They're on somewhere on a spectrum. And if you're, let's say, a 2 out of 10 or a 3 out of 10, that maybe you're more open about that, whereas in other generations you weren't. And perhaps it's somewhere in the middle.
No, I think LGBTQ is a religion. And you choose which religion you want to be in front of your kids. Okay. You choose, if a person is gay, you're eventually going to be gay.
What?
You're going to be gay. You're not going to be, if you're going to do what you're going to do. Like, for example, I interviewed a guy who was a negotiator, FBI agent, who would sit down with people that killed.
He was like, take the cock out of your mouth.
That were, you know,
we can get you a helicopter
murderers that killed their own family.
Wait, dude, do you now understand
why? What the fuck is he?
His mind works in such mysterious ways. Yes. That's what I'm saying.
He said, "You're eventually, if you're gay, you're eventually gonna be gay."
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. Is
okay,
that
so
wrong?
If you're gay, and it means you're eventually gonna be gay no matter what, then that runs counter to his influence argument.
Yeah, no, it is.
No, guys, contradictory. Guys, you don't understand. No. It somehow makes sense. Okay, you just have to have a really high IQ to understand what Patrick Bet David is saying. Just listen to him talk about the FBI Mindhunter guy.
He went to a hostage situation and said, "Are you going to be gay or go to Santa Monica Community College?"
Oh, dude.
Members,
he's so
good. And I
good.
Said, "So what gets somebody to get to the point of wanting to do something like this?" And he explained how there's a difference between what you're born with, what you're influenced with, and then to take the action, right? There are some people that are born who are dark human beings.
Okay. What being gay is like, being a dark human being who's maybe a serial killer, okay? A real estate agent. and also being influenced to go to Santa Monica Community College.
Talks, he pauses, so you sit with whatever the last words he's said.
It's always so good. Will said he's gonna dip out.
No, you can keep going. My car's like 8 minutes away. So.
Okay, all right.
This is man.
Period. I that they that. Enjoy it. They're born that way. You know, if you look at the Iceman, I don't know if you've ever seen interviews of the Iceman. Have you ever watched interviews of Iceman?
Yeah.
That guy is cold, and he enjoyed what he did. What percentage of the world is like that? What would you say? 0.1%? Okay. So are we going to say, no, you know, he was influenced to be that way. There had to be a darker person in his life to get him to be that dark. No, he's born that way. Okay. Are some people born gay? Maybe. Maybe. Okay.
Maybe. But if we, he's not ruling maybe. That out. He's open-minded. Maybe. He's woke. He's saying like, you know, some people just like serial killers are born homosexual.
Take 1,000 gay people. What percentage of them are gay because they were born gay? What percentage of them are gay because they were influenced to be gay? Or life influenced them to be gay? That's a real question we have to talk about. I understand it's a very uncomfortable thing.
I think it would be just attraction. Who are like I am attracted to certain people and a certain type. I'm not attracted to another type.
No problem.
So I feel like that would be the same thing with gender. It's like if you're attracted to men or women, that would be...
Graham,
yeah.
Do you think you need to learn how to give a blowjob to another boy at 11 years old?
No.
That book is in schools, recommended teaching by.
Whoa, he just logic jam. He fucking cooked him, dude. That was a setup. It took him 6 minutes to like arrive at this jam. He's like, yeah, well, that's what they're teaching our children is how to give the best blowjobs at the age of 11.
Well, I mean, like, hold on a second. Like, I wouldn't necessarily need that because, you know, I hadn't been influenced to be gay at 11. But if there was a book that taught me how to, like, please a woman at age 11, I mean, that would be fine with me.
Well, I think that's his argument,
okay,
too.
All right.
That's what he's...
Teachers in America. Do you think that's a problem?
Sure.
Do you think it's a better usage of my time to learn how money works?
Yes.
Or how to please another boy at 11 years old?
Right.
So then you...
Wait a second.
He's saying make the kids watch Patrick Bet David so they get valuetained at the age of 11 and they know how money works. What he's saying.
I would go one step further than that. I would say if you are pregnant right now, if you just found out, if it barely has eyes, you should be putting headphones, the AirPod Maxes around your stomach and blasting Patrick Bet David into your fetus.
So Mozart or anything?
Yeah. It's better than Mozart.
Yeah. They'll learn how to build their own multi-level marketing scheme. I really respect that. By the way, it's top of the hour. I'm going to run a 3-minute ad break right now, but also, which is, you know, if you want to get your money up, not your funny up, you know, subscribe for $5 or free to avoid the top of the hour ad break.
I will take this opportunity to do a bit adieu to the chat. I had a great time hanging out with you guys today, and thanks for having me on.
Thank you so much. Will Medegar, Chapo Trap House, ladies and gentlemen. Where can people find you guys? Or you
Patreon,
in particular?
Chapo Trap House at Patreon.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Also, our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/ChapoTrapHouse.
Yeah. Wait, isn't it Chapo FYM too?
Yes.
Not Chapo Trap House.
Wait, hold on. Did we... Is that
change it?
You only have one Twitch.
Wait, where's Michael?
Have one Twitch chat.
Michael, Michael will. Yeah.
Yeah. Michael's
did
in the
I
chat.
Screw that up?
Michael's in the
yeah,
chat.
Michael will correct me if I'm wrong.
He said the Twitch is Chapo Trap House. Okay, it's no
yeah,
longer
no,
Chapo
I
FYM. Is Chapo Trap House now?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, no, you were right. You were right. I thought it was still Chapo FYM, but the name change is taking place. You get one of those every 60 days, I think, on Twitch if you wanna change it.
Ooh.
No, I also will be playing Skull and Bones in a little bit as well for our hashtag ad. So just for you guys obviously don't have to be here for that. I'm gonna be playing with Will Neff in a little bit.
Is that the new pirate game?
Yeah,
looks cool.
Yeah, I'm excited for it. I've watched so much One Piece that I'm on my pirate shit. I'm on my pirate arc.
Stop! You're gonna get your chat mad again.
Oh yeah. Well, it's not my chat. My chat never gets mad.
It's the bad signal. They can feel a disturbance.
It's the dudes on Twitter who don't watch, but then like get mad anyway, and are just like weirdo racist motherfuckers.
My favorite thing with that, like not to go deep into it, but just like I saw one post where the guy was like, he was like, oh yeah, this guy's just a normal Yemeni, huh? And post a picture of him with like a gun.
Yeah.
And it's like, yeah, that's the weirdest thing you can do in Yemen is have a gun.
Yeah,
this guy's a real weirdo.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, dude who's 19 years old, like fucking experienced the genocide in a country that has the most arms after the United States of America, by the way.
They have a huge fucking firearm culture. It's a gigantic thing over
there.
Yeah,
even all the way back to the fucking swords that they rock, too, at their belts.
That shit's cool. How Yemenis have, like, family daggers. Yeah. I love that.
It's dope. Yeah, also, obviously, famously American kids, they never have guns. Americans don't have guns at all. But anyway, Patrick Bit David, let's finish this off. He's bringing us in. He's saying like children need to watch the Valuetainment podcast
instead of sucking each other off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have to decide your values and principles between the two. I think these values being taught to kids, are kids typically more liberal or conservative?
Liberal.
Liberal. Are you kidding me? I'm all liberal. Like, let's try drugs. Let's try this. Let's break the law. Let's break this. Hey, let's sneak into the swimming pool.
Famously,
kids. Sneak into the swimming pool.
That's my favorite
cops chase us.
Policy.
Hey, let's test this out. We're liberal, right? So we don't need to teach more liberal policies to kids. They're going to do shit. We're going to do stuff. We need to balance it out with what? With this, okay?
Valuetainment.
Yeah. Liberalism is when you break into pool
break into
and, have
swimming
the
pools and have the cops chase you.
I will never forget when Barack Obama made that speech in 2008 about breaking into the swimming pool.
That's what got him. That's how he secured the Cuban vote in Miami. It's just like that's what a normal thing is. That's how everyone operates in America.
So now watch this. Do you think rich, greedy people who have a lot of money, do you think they need to be taught more conservative stuff or more this stuff? Liberal stuff. What do you think? Do you see how this is working out? So to me, it's the other way around. I think we
there ain't no fucking way, dog.
Because again, like you're talking about people's like innate values, which like after a certain point are like aren't that malleable. So like this idea that anyone can just be influenced, like that rich greedy people, if they were only influenced by like I don't know, Valuetainment that taught them to be less greedy, or same with gay, you could just be taught or influenced to be less gay. These are like the currency that he's dealing with here. It's just like he does have a beautiful mind.
Also, I feel bad for the guests. Anything they say is wrong.
Yeah, there's no reason. There's no reason
to have a guest.
Yeah, there's no reason for them to be there. All he does.
No,
is
they're
like,
there because he's graciously teaching them about how he made his money.
Just like us. These could just be iPads that just say yes every 5 minutes. Like it's so unfair to them.
Value, movement, entertainment. Oh my god! So movement is supposed to be in there too. It's not just value and entertainment. It's value, entertainment, and movement.
Dude, I didn't even think. God. Dude, this got layers, dog. You did not even think about that. I didn't.
This should be Val Move Table.
How like everything he did, like all his analogies are like they're like following like a poorly transcribed recipe. Where it's like, okay, preheat the oven to 375 degrees, but then 20 steps into the recipe, it's like, and then what would you say to an old guy who's gay? What would you say to a baby who's liberal?
Yeah,
it's like how did this get in here?
And I talked to an FBI psych analysis guy,
Mindhunter.
Yeah, and Mindhunter told me, you know, being gay just like being a serial killer is very similar. Yeah.
Yeah, no, he said like basically the same percentage of people that are born innately evil is like the same percentage of people who are born innately gay.
Dude, he's so good at yapping. Like, he just he is. Like, I love listening to him because like I love the way his mind works. He always
I think I gotta take off.
All right. Peace, Will. Guys. Thank you so much for coming
on. Thanks so much for the shawarma. Really nice to meet you. See you soon.
Yeah. You're unfortunately not gonna get your money up because you're gonna miss the value entertainment movement part.
Yeah. Cheers, everybody.
I'm gonna be a billionaire next time you see me.
Check our net worth after this.
Yeah. Yeah. But like I was saying, he's like, he develops this yarn. I don't know how else to describe it, where like, it's so convoluted. It has nothing to do with the previous thing that he just mentioned. But he, in his mind, like, he legitimately thinks he just cooked it up. Like, he just fired something that blew your mind up. Like the value movement entertainment shit.
Yeah. No, he's always, like, the second that you think you have a grasp on whatever he's talking about, he introduces a totally new thing that does not help the analogy at all. And only serves to make it more complicated.
Well, that's why he pauses so you can sit with it for a second.
Yeah. I feel so bad for these guys.
I know.
Yeah.
Mixed it up. So be understood. This guy's 28 years old. He's gay.
That guy no problem.
I got plenty of gay people.
You're right. You're right.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
No. Well, he's barely said a word, too. He has not one but two guests. No talking. They're there to listen, man.
Patrick Bet David has been so insane that I haven't noticed that the guests are wearing the same thing.
Yeah. Well, they're very they live ascetic lifestyles, despite the fact that like he's a landlord. I don't know if he is. I met both of them.
I have plenty of lesbian leaders in my company, plenty of them, and see how my relationship is with them. You chose to do that as an adult. Salute. Couple of them were here yesterday. Just watch how they.
So has what he never the asked them if they were gay when they were younger? like this. This is like a 1 second conversation with a person that you respect. Okay, if you have gay employees, it's a weird question to ask, obviously. But like, I love the notion that he has never been like, so what's up? When did you become gay?
But he doesn't even entertain that they could be gay when they're younger. He's basically saying, I think, like, by virtue of them being so successful and smart that they can work for Patrick Bet David Valuetainment Movement, that proves they only became gay as adults.
Yeah.
If they had become gay as children,
you
know, then they could never work for Valuetainment.
Yeah, but it is being a choice. Being gay is a choice. Sorry, and so is working for Patrick Bet David. And
I would say that's biological. Yeah,
some are good choices, some are bad choices. You know what I mean?
If my son works for Patrick Bet David, I'm going to sell him.
We love each other. We have an incredible relationship. Then later on, we need to learn and say, "Hey, man, can you be a little bit kind to these people, dude? Relax. They just see things in a different way than you do." All good. I think we need to give conservative values to kids when we're liberals. And I think we need to inject a little bit of this when we're older, successful, to be a little bit more understanding. I think
he's saying like, teach the older people liberal values, except that completely contradicts his original point, which is the older you get, the less malleable you are. Yeah. And that's, so what the fuck are you saying? It literally is just the exact antithesis of what he previously brought up. What the fuck?
But it wouldn't be like regular liberals trying to convince him. It would be Valuetainment.
That's right.
The new liberal Valuetainment for old people.
He's saying, make the olds gay.
Yeah. They should do like a Gran Torino 2 where Patrick Bet David teaches Clint Eastwood how to be gay.
Yeah.
You have to do this because when you're young, how much do you think of suggestion?
Yeah.
But now that you're old, you now think, I'm never going to have sex with men.
Here, watch this video of Arnold. He went to Santa Monica Community College. Doesn't he look good?
Clint, half the movie is Clint Eastwood trying
trying to figure out what ethnicity he is.
Yeah, so he can say the right slur.
Are you some type of Hebrew?
He's just firing off all of the slurs. Oh, Jesus.
Education is out of whack. You know, maybe the LGBTQ stuff can be taught to people that are older to be a little bit more gentle to them. But it's, you're asking a question. I'm going to go back to it. God is one of them. What's being taught in school is one of them. Not enough money, finances is one of them. The way we turn our heroes into, you know, who the hero making machine is in America is a problem. Today we recognize complainers. Today we recognize who posts more naked pictures on social media gets the most likes. Today we recognize that more than somebody like who's responsible, makes his own money, works his
tail. He's so perfect because, like, these are all dumb guy opinions that he's just firing off, like the dumb guy cliches.
He's
like,
he's like one step away from being like, why don't they teach how to do your taxes in high school?
Oh yes, exactly. He did do that. He basically did. He's like teach him finances, teach him the value of a dollar.
He's doing Latina tweets. When I love big.
You seem very kind, you seem humble, you seem likable, yet you're doing your research, yet you're willing to talk to people. So we've confused kids on who the hero today is. Oh my God, poor person, look at this person. They came out of the closet at 14 years old. Let's do 28 articles on them. But that 14-year-old...
What is he reading?
What newspaper is that? 14-year-old comes out.
Dude, what is it? No, literally, what newspaper is he reading? I need to know. That's the funniest newspaper of all time.
Just only covers gay middle schoolers.
It's like, I read this thing, Pink News.
I can't believe Jeremy is gay.
A kid who made $28,000 independently. Yeah, it's whatever. It's not a big deal. But let's highlight this person.
Oh, and they're not. The news is not covering a 14-year-old that made $28,000.
What would that article even, like?
What is going on?
I love you said 28 articles about being gay and then $28,000.
This is valuetainment numerology.
His brain is so beautiful. He is a beautiful mind, dude. This is incredible.
If I picked up a newspaper and it was like 14-year-old makes $28,000, I would be like, oh, I'm having a stroke. Yeah, I'm dying.
Why is that newsworthy?
I'm dying now.
It's all like, the same newspaper. It's just the article.
Yeah. Yeah. He's like, they never talk about how when a dog bites a man, but man bites dog. It's always in the news. Valuetainment.
Why is Heathcliff never met Garfield? They're both cats.
What are you doing? Which one do we need more for society?
Also, wait, hold on. I gotta go back. In his world, children are reading newspapers to see who the heroes are. It's the kid that came out at 14.
Oh my God. They're picking up like a newspaper called like The Kid Times. And they're like, oh, no articles about anyone who made $28,000 in here. I guess no one's done it. Yeah, I need to go immediately. I need to immediately go to the Who is Gay section.
I love reading my favorite newspaper and 28 articles about a kid coming out at 14.
Imagine like the hard-boiled like veteran reporter who works for that newspaper. I've been reporting since Watergate. I'm gonna break the story about Jaden being gay.
Cy Hirsch covers 14-year-old coming out. Oh, it's so good. He lives in such a different world than like the average person.
More people coming out of closet or more 14-year-olds that are making $28,000 on their own. We're turning the wrong people into heroes, and it's confusing the F out of kids. So to me, those are things that we've been doing that's kind of messed up America a bit.
So if you like this clip...
Oh, wow, jump scare.
Dude. Whoa. Dude, I didn't like this clip. I loved it. I love this clip so much.
Yeah. That is a fucking... That is such a horrifying smash cut because, like, that is a very combed and...
So, at 13 years old, I had a...
I want to know what else he's... I need to see, like, what his most popular video is. Mafia underboss Sammy Gravano breaks silence after 20 years. Highest paid mafia boss. So I guess like 6 years ago, this is the kind of stuff he used to do, like the mafia boss conversations and shit. Yeah. Right? And then he's like completely transitioned into the...
Did he interview Kobe Bryant?
No, I don't... Did he interview Kobe Bryant?
He did.
Oh my God. That's crazy.
What if Kobe died like the next day?
Oh, yes. Oh, there's Kim Jong-un and China, North Korea defector. She's my favorite. But I want to see like something. Oh, Dinesh D'Souza.
He's had Jordan Peterson on.
Yeah, a lot, it seems. He's had Alex Jones on.
Ooh. Jimmy Hoffa.
Show them
Jr.
the clip of PBD asking DeSantis if he's wearing boots. With hidden heels.
Are you the type of person, like, I have people around me that love to say, hey,
bro, this is like, dude, what a perfect demonstration as to why Ron DeSantis' campaign fucking failed. He went on the Patrick Bet David podcast. Yeah,
whatever staffer suggested that, like, forbid them from working in politics ever again.
Like, who is he going to win over here? Like, what is happening?
I also feel bad for the guests because they're like, the producer probably reached out, yo, we're going to have a great conversation. You guys are gonna talk about great things.
Yeah.
But the guy doesn't even say one word.
Yeah. The clip is just called "I'm 5'11".
Yeah.
That's all it's.
Yeah. No, he got so cooked, but because Ron DeSantis has no juice whatsoever, only 142,000 views. Like,
hey, Pat, you got something between your teeth. These are the annoying people in your life, right? Hey, Pat, pull your zipper up. You know, hey, Pat, do this. Hey, pull one of your socks is lower than.
Dude, I can listen to this guy do fucking analogies for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
He's so goaded with that. He's just like, how is he going to tie this to? I'm always watching to see like how he's going to tie this random thing back to like Ron DeSantis being 5'11".
The other one. I'm sure your marketing team points out how they're trying to troll you in the marketplace. Okay, I'm sure they're doing that. Can you bring this one clip? I know you were on, what was it? Bill Maher, and Bill Maher talked about the boots. I've seen you walk with these boots. Go ahead and play this clip. This on TikTok went viral. It doesn't have a million views. It doesn't have, you know, 10 million views. This thing's got 1.2 million likes. And some people are wondering,
what are they? I don't even understand. I haven't seen that.
They've not shown this to you. Okay.
Great lie, Ron. Oh. Really fooled me.
Yeah, and he's doing the thing. Oh, my God, he's such a fucking idiot. He's doing the thing where he's like, oh, I can't see with my eyes. Oh, like you know what I mean? When you're, like a stupid person or when you're, like, a kid, you're like, oh, what is that over there? I can't see it.
Yeah.
You're getting cooked, Ron. That's what you need to open up your goddamn eyes, okay?
Like, he thinks that, like, hidden heels are some sort of, like, crazy shoe that has never existed before.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't even know. What do you call it?
He said, no, this thing has 1.2 million likes, so he for sure saw it.
Yeah, no.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, of course he saw it. He's probably fucking white-knuckling through every interview. I hope they don't ask me about my heels. Like,
to say with this is that in your boots, you have heels.
No. Those are just standard off-the-rack Lucchese.
How tall are you, Governor?
5'11".
5'11"? Okay. Why don't you wear tennis shoes and dress shoes?
I do wear tennis shoes when I work out. Yeah,
100%. You do? Yep. Okay. I got a gift for you. I'd love.
Dude, he's cooking.
For you to wear. Okay.
Ron got owned.
At Ferragamo. Okay.
Oh, shit.
And
I don't accept gifts. I can't accept it.
I totally get it.
I'm sorry.
So if you like this clip and you want to watch
it. What a weird clip. That is one of the most uncomfortable clips I've ever seen.
And then like, obviously, like, the brain dead Patrick Bet David fans don't know that, like, you can't accept gifts as a politician for obvious reasons. But, like, they're like, I don't accept gifts as wild. It's like, yeah, dude, it's the law. Like, he has to disclose it depending on what it is and how much it is.
That was the clip. Did you like that clip?
Yeah. Yeah. It's like, yeah, what is to like of, like, this is the weirdest clip I've ever seen.
Okay, let's see. All right. Yami Park.
All right.
My queen.
All right.
Yami Park, she's, you know, she got the heavies in the words of Andrew Schultz. Like,
okay, FBI Dallas last year. And then, like, two days right before my event, the head of diversity calls me. And then she calls me, my political opinions are too controversial, so she has canceled me.
Get out of here.
Bingo.
At FBI.
Wait, what?
But we agreed that I'm going to only speak about my experience from North Korea, nothing about American politics.
The FBI tried to, she's saying the head of the DEI at the FBI tried to cancel her.
Yeah, this absolutely happened.
Yeah. Well, excuse me, she is a very, she clearly is a long-standing track record of being honest and truthful. Yeah, so yeah. I'm afraid I'm going to have to listen to her on this one, Felix.
Patrick Bet-David, this is like the most deference he's ever shown a guest. He's not like interrupting her and being like, what if you had an opportunity?
You were
lesbian, but you could only live to 50.
But what if
you were born with a rental property that you already own?
It's because in his mind, he's like, this woman has gone through the worst things. Like, the mentally disabled Chinese. The mentally disabled Chinese raped her mother and her. Like, remember how the fucking story that she's told about that? Is like, she's been sold into the Chinese family. Everyone was mentally disabled.
Yeah.
He believes it. He is 100% the dude that believes this shit, by the way.
Yes.
Like, well, oh yeah, you ate rats? Tell me more about the eating rats.
Were they gay?
Yeah.
Freedom.
And they still didn't let you?
No.
In Dallas.
Wow. Yeah, FBI Dallas.
Which is in Texas, which is still a red state.
I know.
So that's very weird. What was the justification?
I was not diverse enough. I mean, the head of diversity.
He's ruining value day, man.
The FBI DEI, head of the FBI DEI division, said at FBI Dallas that she wasn't diverse enough.
Yeah, I'm sure this happened. Yeah. I am sure
love this, dude.
I was invited to speak at FBI Dallas last year.
Oh, fuck. These shorts are
and
so
then, like,
annoying.
Two days right before my event, the head of diversity calls me.
And move some of this stuff.
And then she calls me, my political opinions are too controversial, so she has canceled me.
Get out of here.
Bingo.
At FBI.
I told you.
But we agreed that I'm going to only speak about my experience from North Korea, nothing about American politics, just my journey to freedom.
And they still didn't let you?
No.
In Dallas.
Wow. Yes, FBI Dallas.
Which is in Texas, which is still a red state.
I know.
So that's very weird. What was the justification?
I've never seen this fucking guy. I was not diverse enough.
I mean, the head of diversity.
I'm an Asian defector. North Korea.
Yeah.
You're not diverse enough.
Yeah.
I was invited to speak at FBI Dallas last year. And then, like, two days right before my event, the head of diversity.
All right.
Crushing it right now.
He really is, like, there's like a weird roller coaster in views.
You're the son of a king. You're the grandson of one of the most respected and feared leaders in Iran, Reza Khan, the majesty, who he was a whole different type of leader. When you drop his name, it's a different kind of respect you get from people that are older. You ask somebody younger right now, they don't really know what it is. They know about your father. But your grandfather was a superior general. He was a doer. He got things done and loved and hated at the same time. But I want to talk about your father and the events that led to the fall of Iran. I have my opinions of mistakes that were potentially made. I want to know what you think it was. And I'll make a list. I want to play a couple clips to you. A couple of the clips are in a book that I'm writing that I've been working on for 13 years. It's not coming out. It's something that I've worked on for many years.
13 years.
And he's in it. When I think about the fall of Iran, you'll typically hear about the fact that CIA was involved, MI6 was involved. That's why they fell. Okay. Jimmy Carter came in. He did the toast. If you can pull up the picture when you're looking at the toast between the two, you know, you see this here. When I look at this, your dad looks very uncomfortable. And it's almost as if your dad is trying to be respectful, but doesn't trust an ounce.
They control many things. Did the Jewish lobby or the CIA cause the fall of Iran? What the fuck?
I mean, that's insane, but, like, I just love the body language expertise that Patrick Bet-David is doing.
this photo. Which, it's just like a normal toast, and he's like, I can tell that your father is apprehensive and nervous.
Oh, shit, guys, the echo is annoying. Oh, man, I'm sorry. I guess, like, I should tell my guests to leave then. Fuck, dude. There's no other way to get their voices heard, though, so I'm gonna fucking ban you for a day. Shut the fuck up, bitch. Oh, fuck. I know there's a goddamn echo, okay? You think I'm not aware of it?
This guy's gone, dude.
Yeah, fucking gone for the day, bitch. Also, the thing I was going to say about the immortal science of body language is that Patrick David is the perfect type of person to be like, yes, this is really important science. Yeah. Like, I read.
You saw how he was like hand on the table like this.
Yeah.
During the other kids.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's like, yeah. I read so many. I read so many criminal justice books, criminology books. I learned about all of this.
Of words coming out of Carter's mouth. But he's trying to be accommodating and respectful. And then Carter, at the same time, he's given a look of, you have no idea what I'm about to do to you when I leave this place. This is December 31st of 1977?
Correct.
And he leaves. And then next thing you know, the conditions get worse and the rest is history. So CIA, MI6, the Shah. There's another documentary I watch about the 1954 oil consortium agreement that they had. It was a 25-year agreement that was coming to an end, and it was a way where originally it was an agreement they made in 1954, 50% of ownership to foreign companies. 40% of it was divided equally, 8% each. Among the five major American companies were British Petroleum, BP. They had 40% of it. Royal Dutch, Shell, they each had 14% of it. CFP, a French company, to receive 6% of it. And this was a very profitable venture.
Could you paraphrase this, Patrick? You're reading the entire article.
He doesn't say anything again.
You know, how is he supposed to answer this?
It's a long-ass question.
It's literally the entire fucking article.
At the end, yes.
Yeah. I think this would be so much better if he asked the Shah if he was gay. When did you learn that your dad was gay?
Do you think that the Shah or Mossadegh was more easily influenced?
Yeah.
Because if Iran's grown the way they are during that 25-year from 19...
Okay, I'm gonna skip to some good parts.
Interests of Israel?
I think so. Sometimes they are disserving the interests of Israel. Explain. Because they're pushing around too many people.
How do you mean pushing around?
Well, pressuring. They have many means at their disposal. They are putting up pressure on many, many people. In the media, they have people. Not the entire media. Some newspapers will only reflect their views, yes.
No? The next part's important.
The New York Times, for instance, is owned by the Sulzberger family, who are Jewish. Are you suggesting that the New York Times is biased in its treatment of the question of Zionism, Israel's existence, the United States' relationship with the Arab world?
I will have to put all the articles of the New York Times written on this subject and draw the conclusion. You can put this to the computer and it will answer you.
What you're
That's kind of a Patrick
Bet
David answer.
Well,
no,
the Shah's a little Patrick Bet David.
No, because he would have said, why are there no articles about a 14-year-old?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he doesn't have Patrick's genius, but it, like the response of like, put them all on a computer.
No Ayatollah if Patrick Bet David was the Shah.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just saying, 100%.
Shah Patrick just owns the Ayatollah.
Yeah, if he would be telling tall tales all day, every day, the entire Iranian population would love him.
Let's wait for the answer of the computer.
Washington Post?
What?
The same.
The networks?
Less.
I must say, you are speaking with your characteristic candor.
Pause right there. So when you're hearing that to today, CIA, MI6, Jimmy Carter, 1954 oil consortium, him calling out mainstream media, and then I'll give you this last 20-second clip if you want to play this.
Oh my God, bro!
On not this one, the one where
the king of the 12-minute question.
CIA, MI6, Ron.
It certainly is part of the reasons.
And I think for most people who heard the rhetoric and the narrative of his arch enemies, that he was a puppet of the West or anything along those lines, this proves how much he cared and valued the interests of our country to the point of risking his own throne, knowing that some would not take it the right way and may plot against him.
Very risky.
Well, but that proves his sense of national duty. And
absolutely.
I think then
he's like, yeah, bro, he was being anti-Semitic on the timeline for us, for Iran.
it's also so weird because it's like, no one in the expat community, none of the people who like fly the lion flag,
yeah,
what they're like all
pro-Israel.
Which
is a very cool flag, to be fair.
It's a cool flag, but at the same, like, those people are like the most Zionist people,
oh, yeah,
like outside of like Foundation for Defense of Democracies or actual Israelis.
100%.
I also like he covers the Fiji water with his lion stickers.
Oh yeah, that's probably some stupid thing. Like, why would I advertise for free?
Yeah. He's like, I'm not giving money. Fiji's not paying me.
Yeah.
What the dude.
Jewish businessman told me. I said, how is it possible you got this much money and you're in your mid-30s, 6 million cash? He says, Patrick, there's one thing you need to know about Jews. I said, what's that? When one makes money, five make money. I said, what? He says, when one of us makes money in a business, five other Jews make money. Because we like to make money in groups. I said, so what's the benefit?
He's just repeating protocols.
He's like the Japanese during World War II. He read like protocols and was like, these people are amazing.
They're magic. The Jews, they have magic money power.
I'm going to call five entrepreneurs I know and do a blood ritual.
That's so sick.
He's awesome.
He's like, yes, Jews, they don't make money one person. They make five people make money.
Do you know the Jews are so smart that they call each other before 9/11? He has such a great mind.
He's so good. Yeah, Patrick Bet David talking about the insurance plot or whatever.
He says too many people, ethnicities, nationalities, cultures, backgrounds, they just want to be the one making money. They don't want anybody else around them making money. And then eventually they wonder,
wait, what?
Oh! Yeah, he's going there. He's like, yeah, they hate when Christians make money, especially. And you know what they love, actually? Stealing Christian children.
What the fuck?
He's so awesome. He still has the same demeanor when explaining this stuff, which is so sick.
Oh my god.
In his mind he thinks he's spitting. Yeah, you know what I mean? He's like, I'm fat. Saying yeah. the sickest yeah. stuff about Jews, like
nobody wants to go into business with me. Because when you make money, nobody else makes money. So ask yourself the question. Number one, the person you're working for, does he make money and do you make money? And number two, the people that work with you, who report to you, if they give their best, do they also make good money the way you're making money? Jewish.
God, he's so sick. I'm so happy that there's that music.
Yeah, the TikTok song?
Yeah.
Yeah, the music back there, it really hits. What is this? This is overwhelming. My favorite Patrick Pet David. Dude, I love the PBD heads in the chat. They're giving us like the best PBDs here. Okay?
Yeah. God bless chat. I had no idea there was so much.
Wait, okay, okay. He lost trust in society. Let's start with that one first.
My lack of trust came from people not wanting to debate anymore. I grew up.
Yeah. No, dude, it's like Socrates. He's going to bring up ancient Greece or something.
My mothers were communists. My entire mother's family were communists. 100%. Our Bible growing up was a communist manifesto. My dad was an imperialist.
My dad was
one
an imperialist?
Shah, one loved Stalin and Lenin. So it was a house filled with debate. And I'm in the middle. So forget Hillary against Trump. Like, this was the best debate I would see every night, my mom and dad debating. So I enjoy a good debate. We get closer to the truth. So the last couple of years, what was always America's DNA, we kind of got away from the debate concept. Made me very uncomfortable.
Aw.
Wow.
I like the Patrick Bet David lore that he was reading, like, Marx and Engels growing up.
We could have gotten like a communist or a Maoist.
Yeah, yeah. Instead of Shah, he's like talking about Mossadegh.
Yeah.
He's like a big time Mossadegh head. Why aren't celebrities, but this is where he peaks, I think. Why aren't celebrities ever possessed?
Anybody that's been famous, slightly famous, that was ever possessed that needed an exorcism.
I'm sorry, what? Whoa, no! When it panned over? Oh, he's got... Bro, is this an actual exorcist? The fuck's going on?
Oh, the priest supposed to tell him who
like,
he is.
Let me explain what I mean by that. Like a basketball player, baseball player, an actor, a politician, a military leader, anybody that was somebody of influence, why haven't they ever... Why... If the devil is doing what he's doing, why isn't he going and possessing those guys from preventing them from maybe...
Oh, he doesn't believe him. Yeah. I think he's yeah, this is contentious. You can't immediately tell because he's such a brilliant podcaster, but he's a bit contentious here, it seems.
There's a, you know, maybe there's somebody that's...
He's like, I can't believe I'm getting owned by Patrick Van David.
People that we don't know.
Regular folk. Can I follow up on that real quick?
I actually want to hear that answer, yeah. And then you can follow.
Well, what you hear from these famous people is they've sold their soul to the devil.
Yeah.
That's how they got famous. And so to your point, yeah, I'd like to hear his response.
What? Yeah, you got great addition, asshole.
Somebody would have to come public, first of all. They would have to want to share their story. There could be the stigma that people will think that they're not in their right mind, and then maybe they're going to lose their... whatever position of power or prestige that they have, so they may not be willing to step forward. Goes back to the question again, so why does the average Joe get possessed, but somebody that's more prominent doesn't? And the key would be whether or not somebody is truly seeking help. That's the key thing, whether or not somebody's famous, whether or not they're not famous. Again, I don't go out and search for people that I believe to be
possessed.
Yeah,
but if the spirit gets a hold of you, do you have any control? So if you, even if you're famous and powerful, if the spirit gets a hold of you, you mean to tell me you're more powerful than the spirit?
Nope.
You know what I'm saying?
It depends on the degree that one's dealing with the demonic. Because something of the person always remains free. That's why even somebody that's possessed could ask for help. It's not total. There is something that's called a...
I like that he's getting mad. He's like, well, excuse me, this is my expertise. This is my area of expertise. Like, he's getting a little short with Patrick.
Yeah,
like you put him on the red side
for not immediately trusting him about his expertise of like exorcism,
possession, where somebody takes their free will and they unite their free will completely with the demonic. So there never would be any manifestations then. The fact that there are manifestations would indicate that there's still an internal battle, there's still a struggle that's taking place. But it could be that somebody is possessed, but because they've resigned their free will to the will of the devil, there is no manifestation. There's no battle to take place.
Yeah, but if the devil is so strong, why does he have a hard time getting a hold of other people that are in?
Bro, he doesn't understand. The priest is saying that no, rich people get possessed too. They just don't ask for help, right? Isn't that what he's saying?
Yeah, because basically
they have too much to lose, whereas like poor people don't have as much to lose, so they do get... so they do ask for help, and that's why he's always like exercising poor people, except for Patrick David. I can't even talk. He don't give a fuck. He's like, no, but why won't the rich people
influencers
ask?
Why? And by the way, to say that maybe we don't know about it. When you're famous, we know all your business. You know, the people that get criticism is fame. Like, you know, some people want to go, oh, I'd love to go out there and become successful like that guy or this guy or that guy, and I'd love to have, you know, be a basketball player and get all the fame. I'd love to be a Hollywood star. But the moment you go there, all your business is everyone's business. Hey, this person's brother did this. Patrick Mahomes' brother went through this. Tom Brady's going through this in his, you know, issue. That's why he took a break. That person's going through this. I mean, because even when you can't talk by yourself. Somebody's going to...
All right, it's boring. All right.
Yeah, no.
So I want to give you the gifts I got you, bro. Okay. I want to give you the gifts that I got you here.
Dude, this is my favorite fit, dude. He's so... These guys always wear the skin-tight suits, like, with their fucking... Like, it's just bad tailoring for the most part. But I love that they love rocking that because they're like, oh, I worked out. Like, I need to show... Yeah.
That looks so fucking uncomfortable. Holy shit. His arm is falling asleep.
For me, I got five of them. Let me see if all five of them are here.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Did he bring the other one as well?
That's outside, I think.
Huh?
I don't know which is outside.
There's a box. Sam, if you're watching, it's a small box. Yeah. Yeah, if you can bring that one, that'd be great. First one is...
Okay, so I'm betting myself. I think you're going to love one of them. I hope it goes in your comedy club.
Okay.
I think the other ones are going to be like whatever because you could buy it yourself. But then the other two, I think one of them may make it on the wall. It's a competition because you got like 100 pieces sitting around that's not on the wall.
Okay.
So we'll see what's going to happen.
Give
first
the
of all,
fucking gift, Patrick.
So you're a Jimi Hendrix guy, right? I think you're a Jimi Hendrix guy. Perfect. I got this.
I bought his soul.
We looked up to see what we can do with Jimi Hendrix. Jimi Hendrix did a Montblanc did a special Jimi Hendrix pen that while you're sitting here writing stuff, I know you're probably not a big guy that you care about having a fancy pen or not, but we got you the special limited edition Montblanc pen with Jimi Hendrix. I hope you like it. Okay, so that's one. Two.
Gift shop ass.
I think when I think about personalities that kind of push the envelope a little bit,
Jimi Hendrix on
presidents in the past.
Yeah, Joe Rogan famously writes a lot. Too. So like this is a really good gift for him. I think he's gonna love this.
All the opportunities with the pen.
Yeah.
Well, maybe you'll sign the best deal of your life with the Jimi Hendrix pen.
I mean, people are saying like Montblancs are expensive as fuck.
I know
okay,
they are.
But they're rich guys, dude. Who gives a fuck?
I mean, like even it'll be like $1,500 for a pen. But at the same time, a pen can cost $1,500 or $2,500 or $5,000. If it has a picture of Jimi Hendrix on it, that's still like something you would buy at a gift shop. Like it's tacky. I don't care.
Yeah.
Ask that were anti-establishment people that push the envelope. What? One of the names you think about a guy named Andrew Jackson.
Okay. Andrew Tate.
I this took me a minute to find this, but this is a letter written by Andrew Jackson, president, signed at the bottom.
Wow.
With COA, and he is known as the first ever anti-establishment president, minus the founding fathers. So I hope you like this. This represents that aspect of you.
Okay.
So that's this part. Now, next one. You've gone down the rabbit hole with John F. Kennedy assassination. What happened there? What happened?
Wait, he's like, why is he? Why does he have thematic gifts? Like, I'm so confused.
Is he trying to like fuck Joe Rogan? Like, dude, this is so weird.
Yeah, this is
wild. All this other stuff. So let me see what we can find with this. This took us a minute to find as well.
This piece, Joe, is the actual.
What the fuck?
Where am I supposed to hang that?
Okay.
Signed by Gerald Ford. Okay, the letter to the right is the Warren Commission. Then you have the...
Bro, this is the ugliest framing of all time.
It's gaudy. It's very perfect.
This is so like... Like, what the fuck is this gift, dude? This is awful.
He just ran a picture of Lee Harvey Oswald in there. This is so bad.
The autograph of Jack Ruby. Then you got the autograph of Lee Harvey Oswald. And you got the autograph of John F. Kennedy.
Wow.
Yo, there ain't no way. Man. He's like, wow, sick.
Wow, you got like Lee Harvey Oswald's autograph?
Wow.
Okay. And then the last one, I'm convinced...
He's like, I need you to put this in your comedy club.
Yeah. That's a great piece for a comedy club.
Okay. This last one took us a minute to find.
And how long were all these gifts like?
It took him a minute.
I have a feeling this one's going to be the most insane.
Okay. Who's one of your favorite comedians of all time?
Richard Pryor.
Who else?
Lenny Bruce.
Okay. So I called around. And I spoke to Lenny Bruce's daughter, Kitty. Okay. I don't know if they know who she is or not. Yeah, so I spoke to her, yeah. And I said, guys, I want to find something special for Joe that's tied with Lenny Bruce. So you open up a comedy shop. This is with the what do you call it, when you're doing is it a stand?
Mic stand.
Mic stand?
Yeah.
Okay. When he would go on the road, he had a mic stand and a mic that he would use. I think this is from 1959. This is the original mic.
Wow.
Lenny Bruce used. Okay.
That one's actually kind of cool. Yeah, I'll admit it. Cool. Yeah, I hate to give that one to Patrick Bed-David, but it's also tastefully framed as well.
Yeah, it's the most tasteful out of it. Yeah.
There's a cool plaque on it.
This is just like so uncomfortable, though.
There's like imagine this chatter is very upset that I've been making fun of Patrick Bed-David. He's like, why are we hating on a grown man giving another man gifts?
Okay, imagine you meet someone for the first time and he's like, here's a signed picture of Lee Harvey Oswald.
One or two gifts is enough.
Yeah, this is five gifts.
Would you have a giant frame?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is five fucking gifts.
It's a
gifts.
Gift with a job on top of it, too. It's like, you know.
I guess I did come with a charm.
But that's different. No, that's totally different. The, like, okay, he, this is just way too much stuff. Like, the Jimi Hendrix pen is idiotic.
Yeah.
That's a terrible gift.
He's like love bombing him? He is.
Yeah.
He is.
Yeah.
I did like that he reached out to the daughter. That was respectful.
Be careful. Yeah. Be careful, Joe. He's going to drop you like a bad habit later.
So, now, if you don't want to do it that way, you want to put the stand, we got the stand there as well.
No, come on, man. That's
if you put the
wall,
frame, you got the frame.
Yeah, we need the frame. That's amazing.
So, you know, for me, when I was... You know, we were wanted to come down sooner. That was the missing piece. That's the one I wanted to get for you.
Wow.
And I said, let's wait till we get that, and then we'll come and present it to him.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Respect.
Wow.
I know for a guy like you, Joe, it takes, you know, when people give me gifts, it's kind of hard to get a gift for somebody that they're going to have a reaction to, because you can buy all this stuff yourself, but the hard thing is finding it. Yeah,
that's incredible.
Joe holding it.
So, by the way,
and just appreciating for 30 seconds straight goes to show the gravity of the gift he's been given. He truly loves comedy, and this gift is awesome. Can't wait to see it in the comedy mothership. It's like, bro, if you're this parasocial with Joe Rogan, you have to be like 45 years old, right?
Yeah.
Like, you should not be allowed to be this parasocial with another man at the age of 45.
Yeah, that is the most depressing thing about, like, these videos, like the Patrick Bet-David and Joe Rogan videos. The comments are filled with people who are like, great to see two masters at the top of their game. You two are proper gentlemen. It's like, no, these are two incredibly weird people.
Yeah, I almost wish that this was like dead internet theory and these were bots and instead of like real human beings that actually have these thoughts. Man is really smart. He slightly plugged his book twice or thrice in the name of gifts, and it didn't feel forced. Even after the gifts, this man's exchange of genuine compliment was so wholesome.
Thumbs up.
So thoughtful. Joe hears someone likes something. He finds it for them, and so return without hesitation to give that to Joe is a really good show. The characters, I don't even know what the fuck that means.
This is like, dead internet theory doesn't matter because it's like, there's no difference whether these are real people or bots. Like, the output is the same.
Yeah.
You're a man. You're an old-ass man, okay? You're a whole-ass dude, okay?
Oh, my God.
Look. This is you, okay? You're this guy.
Imagine
okay?
This is your dad.
You're this guy, 8 years... He looks like Tim the Tap Man a little bit.
Oh, my God, anyway, he does.
And he wrote this in the chat. Like, he wrote this in the fucking comments. Joe deserves having great friends like this. It's not the gifts. It's the respect. It's the sentiment. This is an established connection with everlasting memories, and it'll be interesting to see interactions in the future. Bravo!
Here's the thing. I didn't expect that kind of comment from that guy. It was pretty thoughtful.
No, I do. It's like these guys are unwinding after a long day of like sucking the man's dick and like working at your fucking shitty-ass job. You kick back, okay? You put your feet up on the couch, and you crack open a White Monster, and you watch the Joe Rogan show. You watch Patrick Bet-David give you... you watch Patrick Bet-David give Joe Rogan thoughtful gifts, and you're like, I'm going to write something about this.
Yeah, this is like lifestyle porn for this type of guy. It's the same thing as like travel influencers for women. It's the exact same thing, because like for that kind of guy, the type of wealth that like Patrick Bet-David and Joe Rogan, their type of rich guy experience is like ideal.
Yeah.
One where, like, you have $100 million, but everything you buy is, like,
I don't know, like a pistol with the Old and New Testament etched into the handle.
Yeah, yeah. It's like 14-year-old fantasies for like emotionally stunted adults.
Yeah.
Like,
Jimi Hendrix pens.
No, this is like the right-wing version of having a race car bed. You know what I mean? Like, oh yeah, if I had that kind of money, I'd be doing the same thing. And me and Joe Rogan, we'd be best friends too, and I would buy him cool stuff.
It's also like the emotional tenor of all the Joe Rogan stuff is important to these guys, because it's like there's a very like forced positivity to it. You know what I mean? Where like just everyone that comes on, except for a few guests, it's like, hey, brother, oh, you're such a good guy, brother. I never thought about this thing until you fucking said that, bro. You're my brother.
Respect.
Two lions, iron sharpens iron. And they love thinking about having that kind of relationship.
Oh, also, I do have to kick you guys out a little bit.
Totally understand.
Because I have to do my Skull and Bones ad. But thank you so much for coming on, guys.
My pleasure.
This was phenomenal.
Yeah, thank you.
Wally, you fed us.
Of course.
Delicious, incredible, incredible meats, and I'm very excited. Where can what is your here? Tell the people where they can find your food truck.
That's right. The first pop up is this weekend in Eagle Rock, from 12 to 3 in Los Angeles. The flyer's on the gram. You come eat some good food. We got the lamb chops. We got the beef wraps. We got veggie wraps. And Donor Man's, Schwarmer Man's going to be there. We'll be taking photos.
Schwarmachine,
right? Fuck.
What the fuck, dude?
Fuck, I forgot. I just spent $3,000 on the costume.
Yeah.
So yeah, come on down and then we'll do more pop-ups, but this will be the first.
Hell yeah. What about you, Felix?
Yeah, you can find us anywhere podcasts are broadcasted, Spotify, YouTube, etc. We are, of course, on Patreon. And we have some exciting new limited series that we are working on that hopefully we will be able to put out soon. And, of course, our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/ChapoTrapHouse.
He also has a shawarma machine.
I'll also be cooking much worse and shittier shawarma at a different location.
All right. Hell yeah. All
right, brother.
You guys didn't bring me any gifts, so fuck you guys. You know what I mean?
Just kidding. Do you know where to find Lenny Bruce's daughter?
Yeah. All right. Does Felix stream? Yeah, at the Hasanabi broadcast. You can find him periodically as he visits. Whose glasses are these? They might be Will's, maybe.
I feel like I've seen these here before.
No, those aren't. Those are Ray-Bans. I have like those types of glasses, but not Ray-Bans. That was awesome. What a day. What a day, chat. Do we enjoy that? Do we enjoy having a fun day with some friends? Wait, what? What the fuck? Hasan? Hasanabi? Hasan is bi? Wait, what? Wait, no. No, this is not true. This is not true, Patrick but David. I fucking love. What a wonderful, what a phenomenal experience, dude. Patrick but David, the goat. My king, my goat. The legend. Okay, Skull and Bones. Let's do it. Skull and Bones. Okay. Hell yeah. Playing Skull and Bones with Will Nav OTK. With OTK Will Nav. Hashtag ad. Right? That's what I got to put in there. Hashtag ad. Open beta has started on February 7th. Careful, this game has water in it. I know. This stream is sponsored by Ubisoft. Also, the top of the hour ad break is upon us. I'm going to hit that right now. Okay, 3-minute ad break. And then, talking to some real people, so refreshing at the brain rot segment earlier today. Listen, dude, listen. That's fine. Sometimes we do a little bit of drama, but it's like not that crazy. We did a little bit of drama. Okay? Just a little bit of drama. This stream is sponsored by Ubisoft. I'm going to put the panel in real quick, even though the panel image that they send me always is so massive that I don't know if we'll be able to upload it like that. Let's see. Let's try it. Okay. Clicked on my page. Okay. Okay. Do a panel. Add the panel here. Okay, here it is, here it is. Desktop, downloads, Skull and Bones panel image. It's going to be too big. There ain't no way they're going to let this fly. Use provided link for panel image. Okay. Yeah, image is too big. Okay, of course it is. I don't know why. I don't know why these guys, like brands, will send me an image. Okay,